to think that I could not go on, and life was nothing but an awful song. But now I know the meaning of true love. I'm leaning on if I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly, I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day, spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar, I see me running through that. I believe I can fly. See, I was on the verge of breaking down. Sometimes silence can seem so loud. There are miracles in life I must achieve. But first I know it starts inside of me. Oh, oh, if I can see it, then I can be it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly, I believe I can touch the sky. Think about it every night and day, spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar, I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly, I believe I can fly. Oh, I believe I can fly. Cause I believe in you. Oh, if I can see it, then I can do it. I can do it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly.
I can fly.
I believe I can fly.
I can fly.
I believe I can fly.
I was scared. I was so scared. To those that might have not been in here just about, 30 minutes ago. I played last night, right? Played 2K last night, literally 10 hours ago. Within 10 hours, there was an update, apparently. An 18 gigabyte update. So we're in the middle of the stream, I launched the game, bam, you need an update, bam! All save files, gone. Said they needed to override them. I was like, no, don't you do it. I had a panic moment on stream there. I was like, damn it, I'll be back. I gotta get this stupid thing downloaded. I just take the Ethernet, bop it right into the back of the PlayStation, make it download quicker. Girth was too much for 2K. Girth was too much. But yeah, I think it does automatically save to the cloud or something. Found the files, download those real quick, launch the game again, and it was bam. And I was like, yes. I was gonna maybe cry. But given all of our stressful times.
Welcome to NBA 2K TV. I'm Alexis Morgan.
And I'm Chris Manning. Who is ready for the
18 gigs? It's an 18 gigabyte update. Luckily, the internet is very, very fast.
This is my favorite season right here.
Absolutely. We got the highest available internet in our area.
The influx of all these new rookies.
Download it quick. Yeah, I got it downloaded in about 10, 15, 20 minutes, whatever it was. We're back. Whew. I'm so happy. Oh, Girth right into it. I'm going to pop away from the camera here. Let's see what's Girth got. Is there an interview? Maybe? No, I think he's just getting off the bus. Yeah, he's just getting off the bus. Never mind.
2K Sports welcomes you to the following...
Surely it's not making me play the Warriors again.
It's the 2K Sports.
I just played them last night. I just wanted to end. I quit the game at the very end. Oh,
against the Chicago Bulls.
Damn it! I did play against the Heat already. There's just an interview after the game, and I didn't want the stream to miss out on the interview. I mean, you guys missed out on a decent amount. But I went off in this game. I had 30 points.
We are in December. A look at Chicago. Right now they're in 7th in the conference. Looking to
12-11 now. We started. I can't remember what our record was last time I streamed.
And you know, for the Heat, they haven't packed
in. We're back.
Big surprises into the early part of this season. They're right in the middle of the NBA's pecking order.
I don't think they'll stay there.
Turn it down a little bit.
I think they've got a great chance to climb up in the standings.
let me know how the sound is for you guys.
Get more settled,
too loud, too quiet,
etc.
If I'm too quiet. All right, baby.
Brooks is out there with Markkanen.
Girth gonna give it to you.
Girth gonna give it to you.
In the middle, it's Olynyk.
Yeah, they got me at center this game. Girth is just so big. They're like, we got to put him at center. He's a 6'9 center. That's unheard of. That's like Ben Wallace. Ben Wallace is one of the best defenders. One of the best shot blockers, probably in league history. Dude was a monster.
Playoff runs, long championship runs,
and I say that being a Pacers and Bulls fan, I don't like Detroit. But D Rose is on Detroit now, so it's kind of like,
you're starting to rest guys, and there's no benefit at the end. If there's a benefit,
give it up to Girth.
For the players,
organization,
and fans, give it up. I'm all forward. But if it's not, I don't like to see guys rest.
Girth's going for 30 this game, guys. I'm gonna tell you right now, I'm feeling it. I'm feeling it.
Tonight. I can feel it down in my plums.
First one go through the net.
He kicks it to Waiters.
Bring it on.
Passes it to Butler.
Locking down Adebayo.
5 on the clock. Waiters against Levine. Waiters no luck.
The defense ready for him on that possession. They had to be, because he is so
Girth
strong.
Gonna give it to you.
That one falls. Brooks has got his.
He's a rim runner, baby.
Beautiful find by Levine there. Takes his time to survey the floor.
Adebayo is just so slow.
Looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Here's Dragic. First shot, first pass. He's out of the box fast.
That's nice. A heck of a shot.
Stopping short of the rim, just laying it over the top.
And now we'll go to David Aldridge, who had a chance to talk with Eric Spoelstra.
Thanks, Kevin. He told me that doing a good job defending the perimeter would get everything else going. He
said, Girth from way out.
Off their spots and make them do things they're not used to.
See, well, Girth pulling up from.
We'll see if they can execute that strategy, Kevin. Back to you.
About 30 feet
David,
out.
Thank you. Obviously, the three ball is a big concern for any defense. And here is Waiters. After the three-pointer from Brooks, stolen
Give
by
me
Brooks.
It. Give me it. Give me the loop.
Pass to Markkanen. Kick out to Levine. Outside Porter. Pass to Brooks. A three ball.
Too much space.
Bulls with the fresh shot clock.
Yeah, I did have Jimmy. I had Jimmy Butler on me. I shouldn't have shot that.
They have really found a
His defensive rating's too high, and I'm sure that's why I missed.
This game. Rockets the pass to Waiters. Rockets left side.
Don't give that to Girth. He was just messing with you the last stream. He's the MVP. This stinks. We got up to like 9 people here to start last stream.
First chance of the line tonight.
Maybe they'll see we're live again, hopefully.
A rare bad trade by the San Antonio Spurs. Dragic was their second round pick.
Girth is going to give it to you.
They traded his rights to the Suns.
Oh my God.
Catching up on the changes with Miami. Leonard, he's checked in for Otto Bayer. Johnson comes in
Go
for
through, Saturday.
Justin Winslow in for Waiters.
Whoops
against Leonard.
That was stupid of me.
Leonard with the steal.
I shouldn't have told him to pass it. That's on me.
Good
That's on me.
Line speed makes Winslow a dangerous finisher on the break.
Well, you look at the career of Dragic. Greg, he's always been a scoring point guard.
Girth. Girth is just knocking down right now.
To lean more and more on his outside shot. Even
you seeing this man?
Speed start to falter. He'll find ways to put up points.
And here's Winslow. After the three-pointer from Brooks. Butler deciding where to go with it. Shoots over Satoransky. And it's
a hell of a shot.
Jimmy Butler.
It's Jimmy Buckets, man.
Mid-range game. And it's where his
They're about to take me out.
Most accurate.
And the first time out
Heck of
the
first quarter. 2 points or 10 points, 2 rebounds, a steal.
A win against the Warriors.
Yeah, they got into a terrific
couple tray balls
offensively, but a lot.
Archie Diacono kicks to Brooks.
Too much space. Oh.
No luck that time in the shot that would have put them on top. In the middle, it's Olynyk and Adebayo. Dragic and Waiters and it's Winslow.
How about pin that?
The small forward. That's the group on the floor for Miami.
Look, Carlos, cheerleaders.
Here is Archie Diacono. He's guarded by Dragic. Brooks dishes to Markkanen.
Look at the movement.
Back to Brooks. Over Adebayo.
That was a weird shot. I don't know why it shot it like that.
And it's Miami the other
really
way.
Weird.
Defeated by the Wizards in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
In the NBA, you've got to keep pace. It's a fast track out there, and I thought their lack of hustle defensively was the story.
I just realized we're wearing the 2K shoes. I need to change that.
A lack of
I don't know how that happened.
But it's very rare. And there's a pattern starting to take shape here.
I can never get salty with Girth.
Inside,
never.
Getting good shots from close range.
The Heat shooting their third free throw attempt of the game.
See what you got, Murray.
For them at the line thus far are really poor.
Why are you not dunking, Girth?
Sure they are making a point of it. Yeah, and there it is.
I need to go look at my animations or whatever.
They've established
it's like the
inside
because I was playing last night and he like would not
One
dunk.
Criticism of Jim Boylan before getting extended was his offense called too slow and too methodical. He addressed that this offseason by getting a top assistant to redesign the offense.
And
gets hacked out to play a three-point possibility if he can convert.
X gonna give it to you.
Complete game of Otto Porter. Overplay him, and it's a good bet he'll find a overplay.
Oh, also I found out how to
at the line tonight.
You can have like a secondary nickname. I forgot. Hold on. Not gonna let you guys make fun of me for sitting in a pink chair. Hers is very comfortable, but somebody said it earlier. I think it was Joseph Stalin.
I got this cord going on me.
Yeah. Oh wait, I'm writing the. I think I'm. Hold on. I think I'm on over there. Yeah, I'm over the score. It's still not all the way. Where is this coming through at? Ah, that's annoying. That's really annoying. If I just try to... Make me a little bit smaller. I really need to be on that side. I can't go too low, though. How is this happening? Does that fix it? I need to, like, That's so annoying to me. Probably annoying to you guys too. Yeah, it's just a big. I needed to like stay over here. What is going on? I don't know what to do to get it to stay. Why is that not staying over? I can't believe this. This has never been a problem, and now all of a sudden today it's a problem? Like, why is this not? I don't understand. I'm gonna try to sit like this, I guess, to where I can cover it up. It's like worse now. This has never been a problem. Like, this side has never been a problem. I don't understand how now it is. This is really, really irritating. And yes, it is amateur hour, Brandon. This is fucked. I just want to, like, pull this out. This might work. That worked. All right, cool. All right. Sorry, I'm such an idiot. Yeah, that would have been a lot easier, wouldn't it, Bran? Stupid! Dang it, I wish I could hit it. That last one was probably the best smack album.
As a team.
Amy's out working. Hey, Roughneck, what's up, man? Yeah, Bran, you kind of missed it. I thought we lost everything. I thought we lost everything for a second, like all saves on 2K. It said like the save data had corrupted or something like that, and there's an update. There's an 18 gigabyte update in the matter of me playing last night at two or three in the morning. I played at 2 or 3 in the morning last night, and then a guy on the stream, and then I was like, oh, 18 gigabyte update. My gosh. But yeah, I thought I like lost all of it for a second.
Brooks finds Markkanen.
Give me it! Come on, Girth!
Markkanen's got it all tied up now for Chicago.
I still feel like this is really loud. Is that any... I don't think that's changing.
For the Miami Heat. Now the pass to Autobahn. Dishes to Waiters. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Not on Girth. No. The last one we had 19 on the PC, but I was like, dude, I don't know, man. Like, there was nobody to play with as far as like.
He knows how to win.
I mean, not that I played the part, but even like when you try to do stuff that you needed to play like online, like some of the my team stuff and all that, like there's just. It would never find games and stuff. There's a gigantic player base on a PlayStation. That, and it was like, it wasn't even that worth it because, like, we ended up having a lot of problems with, like, the encoder overload and, like, it on PC is just, like, it was just hard. It was hard on the PC. I'll tell you that right now. It was just way easier to get on here. Plus, I can get the trophies.
Going with an almost entirely new group here.
I wish, I mean, Steam kind of does, but I don't care about it, I feel like, as much. And Steam's is actually probably better, because you can actually do stuff with your achievements. Like, I've started to care about him a little bit more, because we've gotten so many games now. I think we have 30 games on Steam now.
He brought energy, and he brought it on the glass.
Hell yeah, Girth.
Brooks has got rebound number 5 here tonight.
Who's gonna cut? Anybody gonna cut? Alright, cool.
Outside Levine. Brooks, the pass to Hutchison.
Good on the triple. Girth is gonna give it to you.
X gonna give it to you.
And he's on the board for 3.
You're darn right.
Here's Dragic. And that's it for the first half of action. What's been a very
What's up, Joseph?
Bulls lead by 2. A chance now to send it over to David Aldridge.
How you been?
David.
Hi, how are you?
Kevin, thanks. Here with Jimmy Butler. Jimmy, you have come a
I'm
long
here with
way
Jimmy Butler.
You... Thanks, David. That's David Aldridge, guys. He actually played in the NBA. I believe he played for the Blazers. Look at that Girth. Ah, I'm right over him. He's a little low. A little low on the screen.
Focus. Yeah. All right. Can't let up.
Gotcha.
Right, can't let up.
Guys gonna pounce.
All right.
I gotta go talk to coach.
Right, do you think?
I gotta go. I gotta go do a line with coach. Psh. I guess that's a thing. Like, there used to be a thing. I guess like in MLB and all that kind of shit. Like in the major leagues, they do. I guess they do all kinds of crazy shit. People like drinking beer in the dugout like during games and shit.
If he got it down low on the block, I have to credit them for their patience.
We really need Kobe White back.
They understood the matchup and they took the necessary time to exploit it.
And tipping off the second half, here's Jim Boylan's 5. Porter and Markkanen, the duo at forward.
Then it's get off him, he's Girth.
Zach Levine and is Archie Diacono in at the point.
He's a big man. He's got a lot of girth. Girth Brooks.
Last season was the lowest rate ever for turnovers in the NBA. It was terrific.
It was, and I think the reason why is teams are doing a good job offensively of sharing the basketball. There's not a lot of over dribbling.
Yeah, that's kind of my fault.
Also the 3-point shot. Guys are not driving the basketball because that can create turnovers. With the chance of driving it, they're catching and they're shooting from a long distance.
They just suck at playing defense. Girth's gonna knock one down right here.
Here's the 3, and the Bulls another 3.
Guys, his consistency in terms of
Girth is gonna give it to you, whether you like it or not.
Outside Dragic.
That sounded really bad, and you could probably get in a lot of trouble for it.
Finds Butler.
Come on, Lowry. Lowry Markkanen.
That shot off the mark.
Porter. Let me get through this. Oh my gosh.
Nice ball movement here by Chicago.
Oh baby.
To the paint.
I was gonna back him down, but and then you're gonna gotta be kidding me.
And
the Bulls get it back. Miami.
I could have backed Dragic down so easy, and you had a wide open layup. You want to pump fake the shit out of that ball? What's up, Chrome? His consistency is like pudding.
With the fadeaway. Butler missing again. And here's Brooks. He'll bring it up for the Bulls.
Look at... Just you got to do better than that. Girth's going to take advantage of that all day. I'm going to be a peeing machine, dude. I've already had like half a pot of coffee.
And the Bulls had Boylan step in as an interim coach last season.
2K's drove me to drink.
Decided to give him the keys to the car this year as well.
A surprise move as Boylan immediately was at odds with the players. Management sided with the coach. Interesting message to...
Girth is going to the Hall of Fame. Don't you doubt it. Pass it in. See, this is what I don't understand. You want to face guard me? Like, all right.
Pass to Archie Diacono.
Get out of here. I need to blop a tray ball. See, this is what I'm saying. I can get back cuts for days.
Outside, marking it. Six on the shot.
Give me
clock.
It.
Brooks outside.
Go ahead, Zach.
Get off a shot here. For three, Levine. Offensive rebound. The second effort.
Ooh! Girth about gave it to him.
First free throw is good.
In Miami last year, they had a shooting.
Girth's gonna give it to you. What?
In the league in field goal percentage, 3-point percentage, and free throw percentage. Hard to win that way in today's league.
And both free throws good for Brooks. Steve, when you look at the Heat's roster, what you
guys
really
don't forget to smack that like, hit that subscribe button to help us out with the Al Gore rhythms.
Your health.
It's for your health.
Roster construction is a
Rasta.
Thing.
Rasta
Miami
control.
A talented front office.
No, you didn't. That's Girth's ball. Slam it home, Levine. Slam it home, buddy. Sorry, I'm getting a little weird. The Al Gore rhythm. It's the Al Gore rhythm. Don't you know? Never heard? Girth has activated takeover mode.
Waiters outside. Now here's Dragic. Five to shoot. Back to Waiters.
I knew I was taking a risk by contesting that shot, but I should have waited to turn on the takeover mode.
Back to Adebayo.
Yeah, just let my dude get a board. Girth's just hopping around over here. Why did I turn my thing on so quick? I should have waited until I got down here and then turn on the... You're not in my area.
No, Daddy, no!
Now here's Waiters. Ball's knocked loose. Pass to Winslow. Here's Adebayo. Here's Dragic. The rebound by Archie Diacono.
They keep calling this
in,
number,
run in, run
which
in.
Is partly how they've dug this hole.
They get it
dug in this hole. They dug a hole.
Chance bucket. Brooks has got the lead up to 11 now for Chicago.
Really another fantastic offensive rebound and putback. This is the second game in a row where he has just been ball dominant. When he gets into one of these grooves, you never know how long they're going to last. Sometimes they go on and on.
Porter with it. Now guarded by Winslow.
This Bulls team is about to be tight this year, man. On my career right here, the point guard usually, the starting point guard wouldn't be Archie Diacono. It's usually... It would be Colby White, who they just drafted. And the dude can ball, man. He can ball. He's a point guard. He's got a big old afro. He's dope, man. He's going to learn around. It's like, I don't know. He's a very exciting player to watch. He went to play at UNC last year. In the preseason, he was knocking down. Ooger. This is actually perfect because they're probably about to sub me out. One rebound, baby. One rebound.
What I love, Kevin, is a guy.
There's our 30. Told you we were getting 30. Freeloader. Ooh. Nice.
What's going on with the starters? Also, he's
dude, I got screwed out of a trophy too.
They don't need time to adjust to the game. They come in and make an immediate impact.
Oh, what are you doing? For Justice Winslow. The Bulls. I figured he was gonna miss it so I could get away with trying to get the board.
Porter, bounce pass, Brooks. Miami
grabs
the miss.
Gotta be kidding me.
Adebayo's got his fifth rebound in this one.
He's gonna shoot it too quick.
Here's Butler. It's all in by the Bulls. 109 left in the fourth quarter.
And clearly, we will not Ooh. Be witnessing a spirited comeback tonight.
That's it. There it is.
As that would be. This was an excellent.
For the show. Two trophies, baby. I never got a double-double. Hell yeah. I might get this one. Score assist. No, I didn't. I didn't get assist.
Brown performance.
I do have 32. I might get it. I think I'm going to get it. I think I did. I think I might get that trophy as well. Just got to make sure I score assist on the rest of these.
So
I got 32. Get that shit out, Jim. Jim Butler.
And continued dominance against
Whoops,
Austin.
Both of their matchups. Austin and Floston. Austin and Floston in the middle of Boston. My name is Austin. Crisscrossing. Still, I'm lost in the sauce in him.
And the Heat going with a whole new group on the floor. So, Chicago going with an almost entirely new group here. Felicio's checked in for Lauri Markkanen. Chandler Hutchison comes in for Otto Porter Jr.
Crisscross lost Austin and Sauce in him.
And it's Shaquille Harrison in for Ryan Archidiakono. There's 31 seconds.
Dropping bobs
in
a
Gostin. Miami no good on that time either.
Hey.
And here are the Bulls now. They're on a 14-4 run.
What?
Step in the puddle. Brooks feeling it out of it.
Puddle.
Crash to Felicio.
Felicio.
And in on the nice reverse.
That was a nice reverse.
Inspired tonight. They fought hard and at crucial points just made the plays. Especially.
Huh?
Okay. During this last run, which ultimately put the game away.
And so Chicago takes this one and by a big margin. To come into an opponent's building and dominate the way they did tonight says, I think, Greg, an awful lot about this team.
I guess they don't need home cooking to feel at home. I mean, Kevin, just
this guy all kinds of accolades
all the way around.
And that about wraps it up. Now for Greg Anthony.
You guys are something else.
Thanks for watching the NBA here on 2K Sports. So long and good night, everyone.
What you looking for? There's a little bit of coffee in there. It's probably still warm. You want? Huh? You got a thorn in your foot? Psh. Whatever. Thorn. Foot. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Girth is gonna give it to you.
Hey, Kenny here. You were incredible. Season high in points, validating everyone who insisted you could make it into the NBA. Even after the questions that were raised.
That's what I was thinking. That should be it. Huh? I'm just going to be cocky on this one.
Yeah, you know what? This
He went back like that. As soon as I chose that,
I just consider them fans. It's really two sides of the same coin, you know? Anyone who thinks my numbers could be padded, well, check the scoreboard. Who won tonight, playboy? But anyway, that's old news.
Who won tonight, playboy?
Because I'm looking to break my season record next time out. You know what I'm saying?
Know what I'm saying?
Big game tonight, Jay. Grabbing the first double-double of your career.
Got fans. Didn't hurt. More folks to win the game. There we go. Now we go, humble.
Focus on winning the game, but yeah, it feels good to put up some numbers.
Is this a new normal for you?
Here we go, get chemistry up. Absolutely.
I think so. I know some people might shy away from making predictions like that, but I believe in my talent.
Girth's here to stay.
If I'm given an opportunity, I know I can succeed.
Why am I so attracted to Girth? I'm not
stopping up. Thanks, Jay. That's it for me.
Anyone else?
No, good.
All right, thanks, guys.
I'm excited to, like, evolve his look. Oh, he just looked straight into our sword. Somebody needs a screenshot like 2 seconds ago, right when he looked at.
Felt like I was, you know, playing pretty loose.
He just looked at the camera, just like.
And a lot of that because my teammates.
That might be the emote, man.
I think you move the ball well too,
we might.
And strung together a bunch of good decisions in a row. When you do that, good things are bound to happen. And that's what we did tonight.
My teammates found my spots.
I'd like to get to know the off-court Jay a little bit.
Word.
So, what do you like to do when you're not playing basketball? Do you have any hobbies?
I have a lot of them. I love dogs. I have a lot of them. What do you guys think? It's not going to be in time.
Let's see. I like dogs. I mean, I love dogs. I got a German Shepherd and a Rottweiler. I'm actually hoping to adopt a Burmese Mountain
That's
Dog.
That's cool.
Season.
Shout out to Rots.
Big dogs. You got room for all them?
Hey, you know how we do, Ted. I got a whole wing for each dog, so that's not a problem at all. The more the merrier.
That's cool.
I'll just get another wing.
They kind of put some cool stuff into the story, Brand. They've made this story like he's got so much more of a personality.
I said, "Wanna do that
tonight?" My name's Zach.
Jay, what up?
Three?
What's up, Don?
Hey, man.
Good to
see
you. Yeah, good to see you too, man.
Hey, look, I just booked you an interview.
Word?
Yeah.
I think you were wanting to call me too.
Love those guys.
Right? They're awesome.
Yeah.
Look, a couple of talking points.
Thanks for coming, Vincent.
Big. Just, you know, feel free to drop it into the conversation.
Boston, you might be able to help me here.
Okay. Cool. Let's do it.
So, three things. First of all, you only wear Jordans, obviously. Second, Jordan is an iconic.
It's been so long. I know. I feel like this is a lot of these words I'm kind of recognizing. I just can't remember what Kiero means.
Shoe. Speak from the heart. Your own personal narrative.
So,
and third, see if you can work in something about.
Are you asking if I speak English?
Jordan,
or no?
Right?
Oh.
Engineered for
fly. Oh.
People love the fly.
Boss, you knew it was good.
Sound good?
So I just drop that stuff in whenever I can?
As naturally as you can, whenever you can. Above all else, I just want you to be off. Just be yourself. You'll be great.
So, I'll see you later.
This is why Boston's a mod. I thought he was being nice, Boston. I'm sorry. That guy was pretty much just telling us that we only wear Jordans. Hank and the Hornet interview. This is the radio that's always talking when you're in the locker room, like before games and stuff.
I see. Okay, we are now joined in studio by a very special guest.
The studio's buzzing here,
exactly.
Hank.
It sure is. Yeah, you know him as the freshest face of your favorite basketball team, but around here you just call him Che. And Che, welcome into the show.
I don't know where they
it's
got Che. I can't remember.
Hey, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
Yeah. So you are essentially brand new.
What did he say, Boston?
What is it that you think is your favorite part about going pro so far?
Playing in front of packed arenas.
Honestly, it's playing in front of the fans. You know, I've always been a big performance guy. So being in that arena with 20,000 people.
Planning?
Wow, man. But
honestly,
really
it's planning in front of the fans
in the kitchen
instead of playing.
Cook.
He definitely said planning,
you
too.
Crazy.
You don't even know the half of it.
Thank you.
Yeah. So, Che, is there anything you're especially looking forward to in your first season as pro?
Yeah. You going to buy a boat? A yacht. Gotta get that yacht.
You know, I'm real geeked about getting the new Jordans as soon as they drop, man. You know, I'm a big Jordan guy. They're iconic. They're classic. You know, MJ's one of my favorite players. So to be able to get these shoes, I don't have to wait in line. It's so dope. Wow.
Flavor on his feet, and he can't be beat. I sang that one.
Wow. Sound good.
Oh, appreciate it.
Okay, I'm told we have time for one more question. So, Che, who would you say are your basketball heroes?
MJ, Kobe, the room. Yeah.
Okay, well, how much time we got?
Well,
not much, Jay. Keep it moving.
Gotta go.
Okay, well, real quick, I'm going to have to go with Kobe, MJ, LeBron. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm a big fan of the legends, so those guys who I, aspire to be.
Jay, that's all the time we've got for you today, but thank you so much for joining us here, and good luck to you on the rest of your season.
Congrats on all the success, Jay.
Hey, man, Hank and Hornet, you guys are the best, man.
Oh, I love that. Cart that up. So next on Hank and the Hornet, are you taking your calls?
A risky proposition, Hank.
Certainly is. But first, a word from our sponsors. You need some cash out of your house? How about a reverse mortgage? They can set you up at Walker & Associates.
Hey, look, I was house poor before I called them. Now, house rich.
Wow. It's one phone call that does it all. Walker & Associates will set you up with a little bit of money coming your way out of your house.
Yeah, what do you say, Bosty? You might be a little bit behind, Bosty. I know you might be hearing this later, but you might have gotten a little behind on the... I thought it might be. I thought it was saying, say my name. Is that what he was doing? You didn't have to take him out for that. I like that. I like that song. That's Destiny's Child, dude. Bosty, get real.
You guys ready to hammer out this deal?
Yeah,
and so say, baby, right. I love you. Starting with. Ain't no playing games. Bossy, I'm about to throat punch you if that citizen of the stream was singing. No, can't do it. Mm-mm. Gonna need all the money you can give me. I don't care about discounts. We can make this work. Hell yeah. Oh, we got three? Yeah. Sure.
Fantastic. Looking forward to a long
citizen of the stream.
You too, Max. You're welcome. See y'all later. All right.
This is you do have rights as a citizen of the stream here, Brandon. You should know this. I have the power. I have all the power here. I just choose not to wield it, you know. We should legit make like a document, like something we could put in, like a Dropbox link, and it's just like a picture of like an actual like constitution looking. Just make it look super. That's your Brandon, can you do that for us? Can you make us a stream constitution? Maybe write us something up and then we'll look into putting it on a scroll. It'd be nice. We could like randomly on stream just like unscroll it and be like, "Yeah, we will ratify it." Well, of course, after we go through it and such. Yeah, this is a problem. Why we got these 2K? No. Yeah. It just looks so like I don't know. We need. Oh man. Oh yes. Oh yeah. Yeah, we don't have a whole lot in this area. I don't know what this is. Look like we just got out of prison, dude. What is this? I want the orange shirt. I want all the orange gear. Where'd that go? Girth fresh out the pen, bro. Oh man, I'm laughing at myself too much. All right. Look at those girthy thighs. Oh, he loses mod for time. Does he really? If I time him out, he loses mod. Oh, man. I was saying, I think it's been mod. See, I honestly thought... Okay, no, he still got mod. I honestly thought that I could do it and then undo it real quick. So, but I always forget. Like, you can ban and unban someone, like, instantly. Like, you can like, I could ban you and then, like, unban it, like in chat. Like, it's just a link in the chat. I can hit it. But with timing people out, you can't, like, take it back. It's just, like, once you're in timeout, you're in timeout. There's nothing I can do for you, man. That'd just be downright cruel. Oh, man. He said, I'm going full vulgar. He went full vulgar right there. I'm a little scared about what's about to happen next. What do we go with? How much loot we got? Oh, we got 15,000 now? Are you kidding? That doesn't even bump us up a thing, though. I think we're gonna do that. We're going to put our defense all the way up. Still doesn't give us the 84. Huh. Standing dunks all the way up. Yeah, this is going to be cheap. Might be able to... Yeah, baby. All right, there we go. Might as well. Oh, Gloria. Feels so much better. Feels so much better today. And it's not the drugs, and it's nothing. I can't remember what it says right there. I kind of want to listen to that. We're going to listen to that, and then I might play an NF song for Brandon. Because this song's dope, man. I really like this song. Except I don't like the sound of ads. I don't like the sound of ads, guys. I'll put you in the shoulder. I make the constitution around here. Bray, you should legit like make something that's like silly yet sounds like it was made in the 1700s and then but still applies to the stream and the creed of what we are here. I think you can work something up. Oh, I love it. I love it, guys. I love it.
Sleep in the driver's seat. I've been lost in my head for weeks, trying to find what it is I need. Too goddamn tired to sleep. And then there were other times. I'm so aware that I lose my mind and never feel like I get enough. So high that I can't sleep.
There. I had to.
There are those who will never learn. Who build a fire and can't stay warm. The only secret to make it through is to take what's in front of you. The fear of death and the thrill of speed. And all the lights in front of me.
Because I had to download an update. Like, I started the stream earlier. Yeah, you kind of missed this part. Started the stream earlier. I mean, I just played 2K last night. Started the stream earlier. Got it, loaded the game. It said there was an update. The update was real big. I had to update was really big. I had to stop the stream, do the hard, you know, Ethernet to the PlayStation, download it real quick. It always throws that off whenever we take the internet out of the PC. Better today. I'm gonna protect the tent. Back to jamming. What do you got for us, Coach?
Bring it in, everyone. Before we get started, I want to introduce you to a special guest, Michael Jordan.
What?
He'll be here observing with the coaching staff today, so let's put on a strong effort and show him two things around.
Mate, hold on.
Score earlier in transition offense. If someone is up court, we have to get the ball to them. Today, we're going to get up and down the court in some transition drills.
All right. Jay's watching.
Hey! Panic stricken, handle business, not a joke, yeah. Manners missing, travel different, no control, yeah. Time to listen, time to zip it, keep it close. My description, highly gifted, take some notes, yeah. Lack of interest, why'd you visit, hit the road, yeah. Kinda twisted, so keep your distance, be a ghost. Yeah, see, I'm inventive, but quite the menace. You ain't know? Well, then I'm offended. Let's jog your memories, here we go, yeah. I went from nobody to kinda famous. Hide my plaques inside a closet, I just can't explain it. My wife, she tells me that she's proud and thinks that I should hang them. But I just leave them on the ground right next to my self-hatred. Yeah, yeah, mental health, where's my mental health?
Founcer.
Diagnosed with OCD, what does that mean? We'll gather around. That means I obsessively obsess on things I think about. That means I might take a normal thought and think it's so profound. Ruminating, fill balloons are full of doubts. Do the same things. If I don't, I'm overwhelmed. Thoughts are pacing. They go round and round and round. It's so draining. Let's move on to something else.
Fine. Running the game if they don't even know it. Like I'm undercover and knowing to blow it. I come out of nowhere, they don't even notice. The flow is so cold you would think it was slowing. I'm under the weather, but wind isn't blowing. I got an umbrella for difficult moments. You gotta admit it, I'm very devoted. I'm out in the rain, but it don't always open, so what?
Hold up my balloons and cover up my face. I can feel them weighing on me every day. Ooh. I should let them go and watch them float away. But I'm scared if I do, then I'll be more afraid. Tell them how I feel, but they don't want to change. Tell them how I feel, but they remain the same. Loosen up my grip, they say that's not okay. Quiet, 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 quiet. Yeah. Hey, leave me alone.
Off me.
Yeah. Quiet, 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 quiet. Yeah. Leave me alone. I hate when they debate if we're underrated. We're so overlooked that they're looking
too
over
big.
Our numbers, Nathan. We don't do enough interviews or go out in public lately. We don't post enough on our socials to keep the buzz from fading. Let it fade.
fade. Once it's decimated, then you drop a song out of nowhere and all the fans embrace it. Then the buzz will surface again. It's part of my operation. I don't need advice from my gouts right now. End of conversation. Shut your mouth. Yeah, shut your mouth. Better tone it down. Close it now.
Never.
If you make
never,
sound,
Amy.
I'm gonna change it down. Funny how they be acting loud.
Blasphemy.
Coming on it now. Floating round. Man, the kid is wild. Pretty wild. True. I'm kind of funny, but don't really show it. I keep it together, but have a disorder. I go to my room and I sit in my corner and talk to myself in a language that's foreign. I think of a rhyme and I have to record it. But no, if I don't, I wake up in the morning and question my life again, always avoiding. I hate to be different, but I hate to be normal. So I
hold up my balloons and cover up my face. I can feel them weighing on me every day. I should let them go and watch them float away. But I'm scared if I do, then I'll be more afraid. Tell them how I feel, but they don't wanna change. Tell them how I feel, but they remain the same. Loosen up my grip, they say that's not okay. Quiet, 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 quiet. Hey, leave me alone. Back in No Name, I said fame called. Told you I hung up, it kinda felt wrong. Finally called him back, we didn't talk long. He asked me how I'd been, I sent him this song. Yeah, think he took offense, he kinda seemed off. I texted him that night to ask what he thought. It took a couple days to get a response. But once I finally did, he said the song sucks. Feel the symptoms, couldn't miss them, wrestle with them. Then I pin and flip them. Brought some backup, Noah, you should get some. Who you dissing? Mood is switching.
Serious?
Don't come in the kitchen, you should listen.
Really call 3 seconds on me.
My hands are blistering. So persistent, don't forget
that's
this. Hold
the
tension, so bending. No pretending, open-ended. Low percentage, so demented. Whole consensus, so tremendous. No apprentice, no incentive. Show intensive, so possessive. Tone aggressive, watch your step when I hold up my balloons and cover up my face. Up my face. I can feel them weighing on me every day.
Come on, boys! Watch them float away. We gotta play better, Dave.
If I do, then I'll be more afraid. Leave me alone. Leave me alone.
Leave me alone.
Leave me alone. Leave me alone.
Leave me alone.
Leave me alone.
Yeah, leave me alone.
Yeah, leave me alone. Leave me alone.
Hey,
leave me alone.
Alright, boys. Before they call for 3 seconds on me again. Whew. I don't know why I leaned into him. Quiet, 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 quiet. Leave me alone. NBA legend bonus? Ooh, I think it's because he's here. There we go. That's big. Is MJ right there in the suit? Alternate 3 points. Seconds plus 5. Okay, we got it. We got it. We got Otto Porter. That's good. He can knock down.
Yeah, when I grow up, you know what I want to be? Take a seat, let me tell you my ridiculous dreams. I want to rap, yeah, I know it's hard to believe. And I can tell you're already thinking I will never succeed. But I'm okay with it, I admit the lyrics are weak. I've been working on them, I'll be good eventually. I understand you gotta crawl before you get to your feet. But I've been running for a while, they ain't ready for me. I know this probably isn't really realistic.
Go.
And honestly, I might not ever make a difference. But that'll make a difference, I'ma have to risk it. I've been crunching numbers, you ain't gotta be a mathematician. And see, the odds ain't rooting for me. I can't lie though, it's kinda how I like it to be. The underdog, yeah, you probably think you know what I mean. But what I'm saying is, they ever push me, I'm gonna swing. Yeah, I could go to college getting down like everybody else. Graduating, probably get a job that doesn't pay the bills. That'll make a lot of sense to me, forget the happy meals. I don't like the dollar menu, I would rather make a meal. Huh? Make a meal? No, I said make a meal. Home cook and get the grill. How you want it? Pretty well. Everything I see is overdone to me, I'm not a dad. But I'ma get a record deal, say hello to my grow up. I just wanna pay my bills, rapping about the way I feel. Oh yeah, I just wanna make a couple mil, leave it to the fam and the will. Oh
yeah. I just want to sign a record deal. Maybe buy a house up in the hills. Oh, yeah.
Might not be the best in my field, but I guarantee that I'm going to die real when I grow
up. Yeah. Hey. When I grow up. Yeah. Yeah. Hey. I'ma make them notice me. Rhyming like it's poetry. Everything I oversee, I just like to overthink. Mocking me, you pay the fee. No returning overseas. Those of you that don't believe, quiet, you don't know a thing. Quiet when I'm trying to sing. Quiet when I'm making beats. Quiet when I'm trying to think. Ooh. Sorry, I don't mean to scream. I just feel like no one really gets me, and it's sad to see. Cause someday I'ma grow up and show all of you it's meant to be. Yeah. Anybody wanna hear me rap? No. Come on, let me play a couple tracks. Count it. No. Come on, I can spit it really fast. No. You think count I should it. Throw this in the trash? No. Trick ya. Haters go away before I hit ya. I am not a beggar or a kiss up. You don't understand, well I forgive ya. I am not a quitter. You didn't really think that, did ya? Maybe someday I could even be up on the radio. Have a tour bus and maybe even play a couple shows. Everybody in the crowd singing every word I wrote. Telling me that I am not the only one that feels alone. Huh? You feel alone? Yeah, I kind of feel alone. Wonder if the feeling ever goes away when you get old.
Big time. Multiplier. As an artist,
I don't really know. When I make a lot of dough, I'ma have to try it though. I just wanna pay my bills. Rapping about the way I feel. Oh yeah. I just wanna make a couple mil. Leave it to the fam and the will. Oh yeah. I just wanna sign a record deal. Maybe buy a house up in the hills. Oh yeah. Might not be the best in my field, but I guarantee that I'ma die real. When I grow up, I just wanna pay my bills. Rapping about the way I feel. Yeah, the way I feel. Yeah, I just wanna make a couple mil. Leave it to the fam and the will.
Kidding me?
I just wanna sign a record deal. Maybe buy a house up in the hills. Yeah, I might not be the best in my field, but I guarantee that I'ma die real. When I grow up.
There we go. We're getting good points for this. 750 times 3. Is that 2,250? Hell yeah. That's big. Alright, we need to get another one that... Can I just do this one over and over? If I can just do that over and over, I'll just keep collecting the 750. It's easy.
Call of Duty Modern Warfare. Pre-order now.
Screw it. I mean, it's like a guaranteed 750, so like, hold 250 anyway. This free throw is so perfect. It's just, it's easy to green release. What kind of pass was that, dude? Give me a bounce pass. You don't chest pass somebody and shoot free throws.
Hey, Nate. How's life? I don't know. It's all right. I've been dealing with some things like every human being and really didn't sleep much last night. I'm sorry. That's fine. I just think I need a little me time. I just think I need a little free time. Little break from the shows and the bus rides. Yeah. Last year I had a breakdown. Thoughts telling me I'm lost, getting too loud. Had to see a therapist and I found out something almost funny's perfect. Going on up in my house. Yeah, started thinking maybe I should move out. You know,
pack I'm gonna go to the bathroom real quick, guys. Get back.
Clean up my yard, get the noose out. Hang up my heart, let it air out. Air out. I've been searching. What does that mean, Nate? I've been learning. Grabbing my keepsakes, leaving my burdens. Well, I brought a few with me. I'm not perfect. Looking at the view like this concerns me. Picking up the cues, right? I'm quite nervous. Hating when I lose sight. Life gets blurry and things might hurt me. It's probably gonna be a long journey, but... It's worth it though. Cold world out there, kids. Grab your coats. Been a minute, I know. Now I'm back to Rome. Looking for the antidote to crack the code. Pretty vivid, I admit it. I'm in classic mode. Don't need pity given to me, but I can't condone. Talking down to me, I'ma have to crack your nose for cracking jokes. I'm looking for the map, the hope. You see me? Been making a whole lot of changes. Wrote a song about that. You should play it. I get scared when I walk on these stages. I look at the crowd and see so many faces. Yeah, that's when I start to get anxious. That's when my thoughts can be dangerous. That's when I put on my makeup and drown in self-hatred, forget what I'm saying.
Let it be gone. Oh, ain't that something? Drums came in, you ain't see that coming. Give me like lower. I'm just standing. I don't want it. Wipe my face, clean up my vomit. so 750 is the highest. Yeah, there's like no reason. Leave you deep in thought, I can never swim in the kiddie pool. Waited, I've been thinking the cinematic is beautiful. Man, I don't know if I'm making movies or music videos. Yeah, the sales can rise, doesn't mean much though when your health declines. See, we've all got something that we trapped inside that we try to suffocate, you know, hoping it dies. Try to hold it under really, water, dudes? But it always survives. Like, really? Nowhere, you like both throw it? What are these dudes doing? Don't relate to that? Must not be as crazy as I am. The point I'm making is the mind they is got a me powerful old. Place. So which feeding can affect you in a powerful way. It's pretty cool, right? Yeah, but it's not always safe. Just hang with me. This will only take a moment, okay? Just think about it for a second. If you look at your face, every day when you get up and think you'll never be great, you'll never be great. Not because you're not, but the hate will always find a way to cut you up and murder your faith. I've been developing, take a look at the benefits. Nothing to meddle with, I can never be delicate. My even relevant, that depends how you measure it. Take a measurement to back it up and give me the evidence. Pretty evident, dependable can never be tentative. I'm a gentleman, depending on if I think you're genuine. Pretty elegant, but not afraid to tell you to get it. Proper etiquette, I keep it to myself when I celebrate. It's that time again. Better grab your balloons and invite your friends. Seatbelts back on, yeah, strap them in. Look at me, everybody, I'm smiling big. On a road right now that I can't predict. Tell me, tone that down, but I can't resist. Y'all know that sound, better raise your fist. The surge begins, I'm back, so enjoy the trip. Green releases from here on out. Dude, NF is bad. He's a bad man. He can rap his bum off. Slapped.
Let's do this.
There's Jordan right there, but I can't like talk. I'm touching him. What are y'all doing down here? A lot of people down here on their phones. Did you guys see that? Anybody see it? Look how much bigger Girth is than you guys. Get out of my way. Get out of my way, little man. What do we get? Oh, more things to spend.
Yeah.
That got us a huge boost right there, though. I don't trust the thoughts that come inside my head.
I don't trust this thing that beats inside my chest. Who I am and who I want.
Pause that. So we're about to play a game now. You're ready. All right, going against Toronto. They're not even in the top 10. Yeah, not even in the top 10. Time to smack them around. I think we're going to be guarding Siakam, though. That's going to be fun.
I'm here with the number one overall pick, Zion Williamson. Welcome to 2K TV, man.
Thanks for having me.
What's this whole experience been like for you being the number one pick? Because the fans are going crazy.
I mean, it's been a dream come true. Now I'm just kind of like enjoying the process.
You are the first foreign player to go in the first round of the NBA draft. How did that feel?
I've been dreaming about this, you know, playing the NBA, and I got drafted, you know, first round, and it's big time.
What's it like playing in front of the Summer League?
That's
crowd?
The dude, Kobe.
Yeah, they were hype. So, you know, we got a lot of love, you know, when we first stepped on the court. So it was fun.
I mean, I get to see the players, and they're real cool.
I'm ready to see what these short shorts look like on Girth during game action, if you know what I mean. Let's see what they look like. Where is he? I'm not seeing the Girth. I thought we were going to get to see him. Never mind.
The Raptors with a singular focus as they got off the team bus, looking to lock down a valuable win on the road. And the game arrival, sponsored by Express.
Express.
Like a pro. The Chicago River winding its way through the heart of the windy city.
All right, Bulls. Let's get on a little win streak, man. Like we want. We, I beat the Warriors last night. We just smacked the Heat. This will be three games in a row, I believe, if we win this one.
Changed the lottery odds in 2019 to encourage competition among its conferences.
Think you're wrong, Joseph Stalin. I think I'm in the greatest country right now.
For eliminating the draft altogether. Another potential solution, a play-in tournament for teams 7 through 10 in each conference, which would eliminate the need for trying not to win as much as possible during the regular season.
It's having a good season.
However it's done, the league has stated its desire for parity. Kevin?
Great DA, thanks.
And it's not the drugs, and it's not my butt, and it's feels so much better.
And for that matchup today with the Clippers, you know they're going to be amped up for that one.
Girthland. You're in Girthland now, bud. I can't believe we got Girth at the center. 6'9 center, baby.
On the wings, Powell and Ananobi. And it's Van Vliet.
I don't even know where the fuck that is, man. So it's obviously not the best. If it was the best, everybody would know about it. It'd be all the bee's knees.
Every year, Doris, despite the expert predictions, there are always big surprises. Some things that come out of the blue, or they're fun to watch.
We tend to use that word expert lightly because you never know, despite collections of talent,
going to work well together. He just starts it off.
Are there mid-season trades that sort of maybe change the chemistry and the makeup of a particular roster? So, listen, predictions, take them with a grain of salt.
Ooh.
You never know
Siakam.
How an NBA season might play out.
Siakam is talented as hell.
So much long, yes, but so many different twists and turns along the way.
No doubt.
Here's Levine, following the basket by Pascal Siakam. Markkanen finds Brooks. Here's Archie Diakono. Six to shoot. The Bulls need to get a shot off here. Here's Markkanen. And it's good.
That boy. That boy Markkanen.
And Markkanen continuing to
Toronto's still got a damn good team.
I mean, utilizing his height, the D has a tough time.
They don't have Kawhi anymore, but they still got a damn good team.
Now here's Van Vliet in the game against Philadelphia. Very impressive. They get the rebound. And so it's Archie Diakono with it. He brings it up for the Chicago Bulls.
Ooh.
It's a three-point game.
I think the thing I like best
about Otto Porter almost had a beautiful
versatility
finish.
Versatility and long arms because it allows him to impact the game in so many ways.
First trip to the line for him here. First one falls for him. And Coach Jim Boylan agreeing to a multi-year extension with the Bulls this summer, Greg.
And taking that interim tag off his title as head coach.
Take it off, take it off, take it off.
With over 30 years of coaching experience, afforded the opportunity to continue developing this young core.
And the shot goes in from Siakam.
Wow, finishing through contact with a beautiful display of focus. What a job by Pascal Siakam through contact.
And Brooks.
And one.
A shot off that time, and it's the Raptors taking it the other way. Marc Gasol picks up the foul. That is his first
Let's
foul.
Go, baby.
Of the game. Outside, Markkanen. Fires for three.
Dang it, it's too late.
No good.
And the great shooters know.
Oh, I thought I got another steal.
Opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
I'll tell you, I'd love to see someone take the contact head on.
Of course it is.
How welcoming the challenge.
And so here is Chicago after Toronto picking up the basket just moments ago. On the wing, Brooks fires the three.
Bad shot.
Brooks can't get that one to fall.
Let's give some credit to the defense for how they're guarding this guy right now because they're refusing to let him get comfortable.
Here's Ananobi. back to Van Vliet. One up, one down. Two points with his first shot this game.
Oh, man. I had a feeling something like
Chicago
that was coming.
Chicago has gone 1-3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. Archie Diacono, the pass to Brooks. On the wing, Levine. With some arc, and it's good on the wing.
Here goes Zach Levine.
I tell you, we think of him as a dunker, but you've got to appreciate Levine's touch and his creativity.
Well, you just watch Levine play. You can see the athleticism he possesses. Greg just explodes anytime he wants to.
And guys, with Levine, the speed and first step have always been there for him. But you can see the strength he's added to his game since his rookie year. Whenever he goes.
Now for the Raptors.
See, I don't personally. I think I'd rather have Cameron Payne over Archie. I don't know. Archie's solid though.
Powell is checked in for Thomas, and it's Fred VanVleet in for Cameron Payne. So for Toronto right now, on the wings, Powell and Ananobi. Marc Gasol is out there with Ibaka. And
give me the fucking ball, Satoransky. What are you doing? On the shot, he'll shoot. Girth wide open.
The free throw line.
Really, the right play defensively. If you
got to give ball to Girth. You got to give Girth the ball. I messed that up. Wow.
A strength of theirs, 79% on the season.
Well, it was the Raptors winning their last game against the 76ers in Philadelphia. His second
He's
shot
good.
Goes in off to a good start, 2-for-2.
Yeah, that's a. Satoransky's number 31 over there.
2 minutes of action here in the second quarter. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, after five
I'm not sure where he's from.
In Toronto last season, Nick Nurse moved to head coach of the Raptors, and the team responded, winning the franchise's first NBA championship. Nurse has been at this for three decades. He got his first head coaching position at the age of 23. He has moved all throughout basketball, both domestically and abroad, guiding 15 teams in five different countries. After winning it all last year, Kevin, he's finally made it to the top.
David, he sure has a long and winding journey. Thank you. And Satoransky kicks to Brooks. Shot clock at 6. And again, no good by Chicago. The Raptors' Nick Nurse winning an NBA title in his first season. Greg is an
having an
NBA
off game.
Head coach.
The first time a head coach, you'd also
got no rebounds, only 3 points.
Has won it. Nurse often reminisces fondly on those days coaching in Europe. And this summer, he was entrusted with coaching the Canadian national team at the FIBA World Cup.
Zach Levine's checked in for Satoransky. And here is Powell.
You need to go back up. Go,
amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game. And here's Brooks. He'll bring it up for the Chicago Bulls. They lead by 4. Atlanta will be traveling to face them after this game. And that's game 2 of this string of 4 games played at home. Now Van Vliet. He's playing a pretty big role for him at the offensive end, averaging about 12.5 points a game. Here's on an open. Brooks covering with his first shot attempt.
I'll say there's no way in hell.
To the middle. Here's Markkanen. Another miss.
Give me that board.
Boy, 9 times out of 10, that's going in. I'm sure.
Let's go, Gert.
Himself with the miss.
And how about the hops there?
Hey, Foxy, what's up?
Not many guys can block.
How you been?
Shot. Good at getting that deep post position.
Toronto calls timeout.
Wasn't very loud. Oh,
guys,
I think it's because. Oh, that's what I hear. I need to up this again. Here, let me do it again.
Hi, how are you?
He has shown his worth in his first season as a head coach in the NBA. It translates to a title. Absolutely incredible.
Young's checked in for Lauri Markkanen. Siakam is checked in for the Raptors.
Not bad at all, Foxy. Playing a little day stream 2K. I think later on tonight, I'm going to be playing for Ambiguous Scaretober, of course. Oh, they called a foul on that? That's garbage. But I'm going to be playing a game called Tormented Fathers. Or I think it's actually Remothered Tormented Fathers. I think Tormented Fathers was a game that came out long ago, and it's like remastered, but instead of saying remastered, they put Remothered. But going to be playing that tonight for Ambiguous Scaretober. We had a rainy day today, so I wanted to get a day stream in. AKA, I didn't work, so you know. Plus, people have been wanting to. People have been wanting Girth Brooks. They've been wanting to see Girth Brooks in action again. I don't know if you've been around long enough for me to hear, like, how I always do the. Oh my gosh.
Oh my.
And then we went to Oh My Girth. And then we went to Girth Brooks. Instead of Garth Brooks. Like Garth Brooks, the country singer. So it's Girth Brooks. And he is something to look at. I mean, you can see he's got some pretty sizable ears. I just maxed everything. And made it as crazy as possible. Covering him up right now. You can kind of see him.
And if you're just joining us in this one, first half is in the books, one half to go.
Oh, it's a good time.
He's really been playing well.
You just love the patience.
I've like basketball's always been,
you know, as a coach, you can preach
like
good
my passion since I was a kid. So this is, I don't know, one of my favorite games. I play this game like crazy. If like, I don't know, I play this all the time off stream. For the second half of basketball. So pretty much the only game I play off stream. Maybe a little Rocket League every once in a while. It's been a long time.
Then it's Zach LaVine, then it's Brooks.
Should have pulled that.
And it's Archie Diacono in at the one. You can't help but notice the teams are shooting earlier in the shot clock. One theory being the faster you shoot, the more possessions you get. Well, and the numbers would speak to that.
No doubt, Kevin. And the
all right.
Is
we need to go off the second half.
Fans, that breakneck pace makes it more exciting.
We haven't really shot a lot.
One NBA coach told me this past year that your field goal percentage in the first 10 seconds of the shot clock gives you your best opportunity to make it. And the longer that shot clock goes on, the more your field goal percentage dips. So, hey, good for us, good for the fans, good for the teams.
Boom.
And that's because the defense has a chance to settle, correct?
Exactly right. What a terrific play by just a tremendous.
Yeah, we hear that a lot. We have some people that like football and stuff like that. Our channel isn't necessarily like, there's not a whole lot of our audience that are necessarily sports fans, but some of them are. It's something I'm like addicted to, basketball, everything basketball. Dang it. I should have known that was coming. That's understandable.
Now here's Powell, guarded closer. Count that one. Powell's got 6 points.
Put it on the deck, get by.
Appreciate you stopping by anyway.
Powell on the dribble drive. Okay, I see you.
Let's us. That means you really like us. If you're stopping by and you don't even like Brooks, sports or sports games. You
know. Now here's Brooks. Not a lot of room.
Let's go, baby.
Count it.
That makes three in a row to start the second half.
Raptors trail by 7. Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. Now here's Van Vliet. Floats one up. Shot clock at 5. And that's
good foul.
Two free throws coming up. Officials on
says
the
so up there too.
Out of Cameroon, Pascal Siakam drastically improved last year. Doris, is he the prototypical modern power forward?
He is.
Here's Van Vliet. There's the steal. And here we go with Brooks running it up the court. So for Toronto right now, Powell and Ananobi. Baca is out there with Marc Gasol. And it's Van Vliet in at the point guard position. Toronto working the ball around now. Ibaka, no luck.
Boy, if you're going up against this guy in this close a range, you've got to defend with
yeah,
him.
Buddy.
Oh, goodness. What a play.
Well, we're not scoring a lot of points, but we're doing a lot of stuff. Doing everything else. Got rebounds, lots of assists for a center. Like, you don't see centers get four assists.
We're just over a minute into this final quarter of play. Gasol, wide open, he fires, hands it from downtown.
And when you've got a big man who can shoot from distance like that, what a huge advantage.
Outside, Levine. Archie Diakono kicks to Brooks. Porter dishes to Young. Pass to Brooks. Rocket six.
Come on. Get your feet set.
And it's laid up and in by Young.
Hey.
And the Bulls lead by nine.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
I know we just had it the other day, but I'm totally down to get pizza again. No? Wings? Ooh.
Van Vliet passes to Ananobi.
Huh? Yeah, dude, it's like you gotta have them once a week.
Back to Van Vliet. And the pass to Powell. The feed now to Gasol.
I'll pay it for him whenever. If you guys want to go get him.
No.
Are you kidding me?
No.
And then we're not getting him.
Chicago grabs the miss.
And I'll tell you, they're going to need more from this guy if they're going to cut into this deficit.
That bucket in no time.
Another assist.
Archie Diakono's got the lead up to 11 now for Chicago. The Raptors have gone 1-4 since the end of the third quarter. Passes to Gasol. Ibaka outside. Just five on the clock. That's a two from Powell. Raptors get it back. Pass to Gasol. Second chance shot. The shot
bank
is
it
off the backboard.
Mark Gasol in the catch and shoot game.
You really can't go get him. Huh? What? Just do it. I'll give you money.
Here's Brooks.
No.
And contact out.
Huh? No, I mean, I'm down with that. Like, that sounds good. Why can't you just go get it? I do it every time.
Wow, he got way on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
The first free throw is good. Siakam has checked in for the Raptors. And both free throws good for Brooks. Doris, do you think it's more challenging for superstars in smaller markets, mid-sized markets?
You know, this is such an interesting debate in a world that has become, because of social media, so much smaller. You know, I do think that certain larger markets, L.A., New York, can be a blessing and a curse. It does still feel like that media scrutiny is a little bit larger. When things are going well, it's the best thing in the world. When things aren't going so well, boy, those day by day.
Ah, there we go.
Question after question.
There we go.
Probably become pretty tedious.
Their ability, again, to stretch the floor, particularly in this second half.
And guys, boy, when you're hitting, it sure does work. It obviously opens up major options at the offensive end.
Pass to Ananobi. From deep three-point range. And out of bounds as Chicago gains possession. Lowry Marketing's checked in for Chicago.
Lowry.
Chicago leading by 14. It's Brooks on the wing. Launches it.
And again, hell yeah, there we go, Girth. There we
and
go, Girth.
This is going to end in a lopsided victory. I love the tenacity and aggressiveness, as well as the ability to close. You really got to give it up here for the Bulls.
And they're fully in control now, but there were some tense moments, I thought, for them throughout this game.
I'm glad I got the last three in, because they weren't even going to give me player of the game still.
5 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. And so Chicago takes this one, and by a big margin. Even early on in this one, it seemed like they were happy to be playing at home tonight.
And it makes a big difference. And once they start in rhythm, you never felt like they had any doubts as to whether or not they were going to win.
We're going to get a badge by the end of this stream. No doubt.
Thank you, Kevin. Jay, congratulations on the
wallet. Huh? I'm saying whenever you want. That's all I'm saying. Whenever you want to do it, just do it. And you can just take the cash. And take her because you might need her. I'm just going to be streaming. Like, I'm going to stream and then.
Can help you guys the rest of the season.
I didn't think it'd be that big of a deal. I figured you'd be able to handle it.
You know, I think we're getting to the flow of things, D.A., man. Finding our own rhythm, you know? There's a lot to sort out over the course of the season, and I think games like this help us improve and prepare to compete down the stretch, man, because that's the most important.
Well, it looks like y'all are getting in sync at the end of the year, and that's when you want to do it. Congratulations. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you.
Hey, what's up?
Hey.
Let me guess, you want to know?
Yeah, no.
You sure about that?
Yes, just get in there and answer some questions, all right?
Okay, cool. Hey, who do you want me to make the autograph out to?
Oh, I'm gonna kill you.
Hey, I'll see you in a few.
I love it. He's got those tiny little shorts on.
Nice little win streak for Jay and company here.
Which makes us all winners, Hank.
Yeah, look, they're playing well, but let's not get...
What does it mean to you to be in the top 10 of All-Star voting in your position?
Really?
I'm top 10?
You are.
What?
It's nice to get recognition.
We're the top 10 All-Star voting per center. What?
You know, we're all pulling in the same
This is motivation,
you know?
Now, baby. We're putting up double double next game.
So, for me, that's what it's all about. The team.
But to answer your question, Amy, yes, I'm a little hungry because I haven't ate today. Oh, dope. That put us... Okay, that's dope. Okay. We just beat the Raptors. Raptors, they ain't even doing anything. They have a horrible record. That puts us, though, above... I wonder if I lost, if that would have changed things. Because we're above Mark Gasol and Siakam. We can pass Middleton. We can pass Vucevic easy. But once we get to Griffin and B. Durant, I think we can, if we can get to the top, we ain't passing Durant and Giannis, but. Sheesh. LeBron's got 1.8. So, okay. Zach LaVine's up there too. Hell yeah, dude. I like this. Let's go. Girth, Girth, we're thrilled to see that you've been able to hold down a starting role. That's why we hoped you'd become. That's what we hoped you'd become, and we're happy that you're taking advantage of the opportunity. We'd like to reward you by giving you more control over the in-arena experience. From now on, you'll be able to pick what songs play while we introduce you, customize all kinds of in-arena sounds, like what plays when you nail a three or throw down a dunk. Thanks again for all your hard work, Girth. It's very appreciated. Sincerely, Bulls Management. Okay. Smoke Diza. All right, well, I can't hear any of them, so... It's gonna pick the one that I know. Or something I like, I don't know. All right, Let's go with the post. Whatever. Did I actually equip it? Okay. Let's dunk. 3-point. Hey, boss. And nobody? Nobody's always coming in here with that. I don't know if we need anything for a rebound. Hard pick, ankle breaker, turnover, and one. And one. What do we want to do? We'll do the Thunder. I like that. Feels so much better today. Oh my gosh, Boz. I can't believe it's coming already. I'm gonna use the first community the community tab post. I'm going to use the first one for that. I'm going to put the shot up there and all that good stuff. I'm pumped. I've been talking about it a little bit throughout the streams here recently when we've been going, but I need to like tweet that the thumbnail and all that good stuff. Well, should I tweet the thumbnail or should I tweet the like schedule picture you had? I'm gonna grab another brew. Ha ha ha. Feel so much better today. All right, now that we're going to practice, we're gonna go to listen to music again.
That felt good.
Nobody has huge nips, is that what I said? Give me a second here. I'm trying to bring it. Hey, how you been, man? Nobody has huge nips donated €1. And it says, I love Amers hats and bonnets and t-shirts. I felt like sharing that.
Hey, did you hear that, Amy? Yeah.
She laughed. She looked. She said bonnets. Thank you for that. Thank you for that, nobody. That was good. Feels so much better today. Let's try it.
Good to know that you understand there's more to this game than offense. Let's work on that defense today.
You know it. Too early. This is tough. This is tough. Oh yeah, oh yeah. She's got good style. Sometimes. I said no, just to make her a little bit angry. There's no getting to that. I don't know how I'm supposed to. Am I not fast enough? I mean, that was a little better. It's still like this is one I can't do this one. Gotta be faster. Then they change it up and put it on Thad. Like I can't get there in time. God, and then he goes quick. Whatever, that's all right. That drill was freaking, there's no way. That's one rare occasion where Girth couldn't handle it. Girth just couldn't handle it. You have no idea whatsoever on how basketball works. The objective is there's two goals. There's one goal there, there's one goal there. One team is on offense, one team's on defense. But what sports do you know? Let's work from there. Cause there's a lot of similarities in between like the movement in soccer and basketball, for example. But then there's stuff that's a lot different.
Let's get to work. Here's what we're gonna do.
So essentially right now I'm shooting free throws. Don't say soccer again. Here's the thing. Football, the actual football for us, is way more fucking cool than soccer, alright? Soccer is fucking like, we're gonna run around and we're gonna get tapped and we're gonna go, ooh! And then we're gonna fall down, lay around for 5 minutes, and then if the ref reacts to it in the way we want, we pop right back up. We're fine. We're good. Football. I agree that it makes no sense that like you use your foot in football like in two or three different, you know, circumstances. And soccer is all using your feet. So that makes more sense there. But if we're talking like what's better, get the fuck out of here if you think soccer is better than football. American football. Get the fuck out. I mean, it's not that I like hate soccer either. I have an appreciation for it. Like it's cool. The school I'm wearing an IU jersey. IU is bad at they're bad as fucking soccer. Like they killed. They smash people. And I went to a couple of their soccer games. I've been to many soccer games. Say American football is barbaric. That was, I mean, you got boxing and shit. Like you got different fighting. I mean, I don't know. Rugby is the closest thing to football, obviously. But football's just fucking exciting, man. It's cool. Like it's just, I don't. It's just there's all kinds of people that don't really know what's going on. Don't think it's like not necessarily fans, but if you sit them down and they watch like a good game, they'd be like, holy shit, like. They you know, they get into it. You put a couple beers in somebody and then have them watch a football game, man. I don't know. You force feed a couple beers into somebody, they're going to love football. They'll love it. Guarantee you're going to leave with a sword and a smile. Barbaric, barbaric, I don't know. Basketball has always been my thing, though, man. I've always loved basketball. I'm High-fived her. Are you a Steelers fan, boss? Out in Idaho, you're a Steelers fan? I mean, Idaho don't have a team, obviously. But you're fucking... Boise State's tight. The Bluefield and... all that jazz. They're actually good, too. They had Kellen Moore, I think. Was it Kellen Moore? Back in the day?
Let's get to work. Here's what we're gonna do.
Kellen Moore, he's actually, on the, yeah, he's, I think he's the quarterback. It's not quarterback coach. It's, maybe it is quarterback coach. Rams fan back in Cali. So, oh, like, you weren't old enough to be a fan of the Rams when they were originally in LA, though. Like, they moved to St. Louis. Dude, I absolutely did. Hell yeah, I did. I think I had an IU one, though. We had an IU one. I think my dad... Dude, those starter... The starter jackets back in the day were dope. Yeah, this is a starter jersey. Yeah. See, I was born in 92, so, you know, it was like, that's what, like, I remember watching, like, Jordan play, like, when, like, the Bulls would play the Pacers and stuff. Of course, everybody as a kid was a fan of Michael Jordan, but, you know, I was, like, obsessed. Like, Space Jam, I watched that movie, like, 4 times a day. Dude, the Hornets one. Dude, the Hornets ones were dope, dude. That color scheme, like the teal and the purple, like, ugh. Dude, I got to show you, Nolan. I have this blanket from when I was a kid. I still have it. It's actually in my room. I use it to cover the windows. I like having the room real dark, so I just like it's just hung up. Amy hates it, but it's an awesome freaking blanket. I think if you go back to our very first stream, you'll see it in the background. It's like up, like literally our channel's first stream. I believe it's in the background, but it's like, it's all like a bunch of like tiny jerseys from like the 90s. It's all the 90s, all the 90s NBA teams. So the Atlanta Hawks ones especially like looks like it's like the old school and like the Pac-Man Atlanta Hawks logo. And then yeah, it was the Charlotte Hornets Charlotte Hornets obviously were on there. The Pacers emblem hasn't changed ever, it seems like. The Bulls hasn't ever changed. It's just like, ugh. I don't know, the Bulls is just so perfect though. I wish the Pacers would do a little something different. Because some of these new emblems coming out, like, I mean, like, I don't like the Pelicans name or any of that, but, like, the Pelicans, like, emblem, like, the quality of that graphic is really dope, I feel like. And the new Hornets one for sure. The new Hornets one now is super fucking cool. It's probably the coolest one in the NBA. That's dope, Nolan. Yeah, hold on to that shit forever, man. That is really cool. You should try to get a hold of a one from when they reopened in Charlotte. That'd be really cool. I was so happy when they got to go back to being... And like, the Bobcats was... It was just dumb. I thought when they went to being the Hornets that y'all would... I thought y'all would end up getting, like, a big-time free agent. Cause like I don't know, Jordan being the GM and the owner, and then it being back in Charlotte, I thought you guys would get somebody. I'm done. Fuck the whole Bobcats thing. They had, I don't know. Kemba did wear a Bobcats jersey. I feel like that the Bobcats. The whole, like, I feel like your best player in the Bobcats era was definitely Emeka Okafor, man. Emeka Okafor was dope. He was a monster, man. And he was one that lived up to the hype. Like, went to UConn, dominated, and then there, you know, he got drafted high. But then I feel like he did, like, I don't know. He had some really good years. They just weren't good. You know, they just... I was trying to shoot. I'm going to shoot this one not looking. Just like that one. Oh, fuck, I looked. Yeah, I hate the Bobcats. Cool fact, though. Tyson Chandler, yeah, when he plays for the Bobcats, he's looking at me. This big ass. That's my grandma. That's dope, dude. Tyson Chandler was cool, man. He got drafted by the Bulls. Tyson Chandler's been everywhere. He's still in the league. He's played for the Bulls. He's played for the Knicks. He's played for the Lakers. He's played for the Bobcats. He's played for... Or did the Bobcats draft him? I thought the Bulls drafted him. I feel like the Bulls draft him. I might be wrong, though. Oh, we never did a spin. We're going to go in the neighborhood. Yeah, I think you're right. It's something like that. I'm not completely sure. Amy, you got your pin? I don't know if mine's... This might have some in it. Doesn't taste good. Tastes like wood. I played last night, boss. I need to get some shoes for the neighborhood. This is... I love it. It's at night right now. This is what's kind of cool about this game, though. I say it's open world, but this is like the kind of the RPG-ish kind of... Well, it's... They say, like, Madden is like the close, like it is an RPG. Like, if you really break it down and look at it, like it is. And this is in the fact that, like, I don't know, I'm Girth, dude. But there's like cool places, like there's like a lot of cool graffiti. Like, I could go back there. There's a lot of different stuff going on. But yeah, that's the practice facility, the training facility there. They got all the workout. We'll just run around. Steam coming out, and then you could actually go in there and play against people, like right now. Looks like there's only one court worth of people playing over there. Usually it's way more loaded up. I don't know what everybody's doing. Oh, I think an event's about to happen. That's usually what's going on when it's like this. Huh? All right. I guess everybody's just hanging out. I think that might be where you load in. But yeah, like they have different emblems above people's heads. Like, I don't know what that says. Is that Canada? I think it had like a flag boat. And let's hope you can get like tiles for your name too. But you can go over here. Spin the wheel real quick. That's awesome, man. That's so cool. Yeah, dude, that's dope, man. I wonder if we'll be able to do this yet. Opening night right there. No Paul George. We're gonna go Lakers. Pacers, of course. I'm gonna go Pistons. I'm gonna go Pacers. Magic. Cavs ain't shit. Gotta take my Bulls. I'm sorry. We were just talking about it. Definitely. This one's a little tougher. Take them because they're at home. Kyrie, yes. I might double down. Fuck. Let's see if we get it. Yeah, Dragon, we got it. TJ, what's up? I'm here to see the girth in all his glory. I'm here to see a girth. Yeah. Joakim Noah, he does. He does look a lot like Joakim Noah. Give Girth a spin. $2,000. Stop it. Stop it, baby. Yes, I like that. All right, we're going shopping now, guys. We're going shopping. Girth's getting some new shoes. Girth's getting new shoes, Amy. Yeah. That's a sign. We just got 2,000 on the wheel. Carson, I got no idea, man. It just bugs. It's like, this is like the third, fourth update, it seems like, with an 18 gigabyte update, 12 gigabyte update. It's like, what are you guys doing? What are you doing? It's legit, though. I don't know. Like, seems like we bought the game in September, and it was, like, 60 gigabytes. Like, I think we're at, like, we got 120 gigs going now towards the game. Like, what? Like, this is kind of the, in my opinion, like, why, like a perfect example of, like, why, like, I about said shoes. Why competition's a good thing. Like, with live being crap, 2K can do whatever they want. They release buggy. Well, 2K, the publisher in general, they'll just release buggy games and then just patch. Here's a patch. There's a patch. There's a patch. Here's a patch. Of course, I'm just playing on. I'm just playing the season. I'm not actually playing. I'm going around. I'm about to buy some shoes. I'm wearing some. I'm wearing the basic 2Ks right now. Do I still? I don't get it free in here. All right. Garth. Garth Brooks. We just need something cheap, man. I just don't want to be wearing the 2K. Oh, these shoes got to be so expensive. That's not. That might be the. I gotta get Jordan's. I think I gotta get Jay's because the company might get mad at me. Fuck it, we'll spend $3,000. I'm just gonna get what. Ooh. There are some cool ones in here. I kinda like those. Those are also pretty cool. Those are pretty cool. There's a lot of cool colors in here. I'm gonna go with the stream colors. I'm gonna make an outfit that's kind of stream colored. I like that.
Can I try these up?
Absolutely.
He wants to play with Girth. Yeah, I don't have the only I don't wear these to actually play in. I'll go get them. I got some Kobe's that are kind of tight. I've been wanting them for a long time. The Kobe Mentality 2s. Wolf Gray.
I'm not like that into. Well, I got here. Hold on.
Welcome to the guild, daddy.
Hey, Carson, appreciate that, man. These are the shoes I hoop in. No, and I got something different this time. Like, they're actually getting tore up. You can see this all ripped up right here. But these are a little bit different. I gotta play in like mid tops. But these were kind of cool because it kind of like wraps around your ankle. I don't know if you can see it here, but the tongue's a little weird. It's cool because it kind of like rolls around your ankle and then you tie. I don't know. I got something a little different this time. Those are those. Let me get my. Fun. Not talking. Oh. These are the Kobe's though. I like these a lot. Love them. I don't know. I've been wanting to get these for a long time. These are just like the everyday shoes. I wanted something that I could wear with everything. It's like the only like wearable shoes I got. I don't know, I got some cool like Timberland boots actually. They're like black suede Timberland boots and the top of it's like a gray. Yeah, we appreciate that, Carson. Yeah, that's what I'm wearing. I don't know, the black looks dope. The purple looks, they all look kind of cool. I'm gonna go black.
These are sick. I'll take
them. What's up, Dirk?
Perfect. Great choice.
We're on a shopping spree right now, Dirk. We just had these generic ass 2K shoes. I was like, I can't do that anymore. I can't. Oh, I can use them in the game too. See, it was weird though. On the other one, it would let you choose like your away and your home outfits. Kind of like, yes, I can wear it for all. Yeah, we're doing it. We're doing it. We're being that guy. There's a hot dog place now? Hot dog diner. Look at that, daggone. Late night ramen. Dude, I think this is new. I haven't even seen that. The neighborhood. I don't want to go into my team yet. I want to be in like top I can be.
Thanks for coming in.
DJ, too. Everybody just popping in. What's up, everybody?
I'm talking rainforest sweaty. I'm talking swamp sweaty. Let's fill the bathtub full of sweat.
Ooh. I don't care about all the Halloween shit. I need a... I don't know what I need. Too much. What's, oh my gosh, this is big time money. Big time money, we don't need that. I can be a mess. Oh, Girth would look great sleep. Oh, Girth. Oh, man, we don't have enough money. That's all right, though. We're coming back for you. We are coming back for you. You're perfect for Girth.
These are all great, but I think I'm going to come back later.
Okay, anytime.
TJ, TJ, being an adult is not for me. I'm over it. How you doing, Dark, TJ, DJ, Nolan?
Carson. Who else we got in the chat? Make yourself be known. Guys, if you haven't already, do what Carson did. Hit the subscribe button if you're new. Hit the like button as well.
For your health.
It's for your health.
I'm gonna fix this little green screen. This hat.
I'm moving the camera. Alright, I think we're good. Neat. I'm home setting up my HD60 I got from Gigs. I got an issue that apparently does not exist on the internet. What's going on with the Dark? I don't know, you would already know about the, was it the HDCCP or whatever you have to enable, disable, or whatever on your PlayStation. Because that sometimes will make it to where it won't even get a signal from the Gato. Hopefully you're just forgetting about that and that might be your issue. Because it should work fine. Like, that art's really cool right there. Docs, that's the haircut place. But yeah, game's dope. 17-5, 3 assists. We need to get up to 20 and like 8. So we need to start rebounding. Alright. Hawks are about to get dominated. Hawks aren't even in the top 10. Yeah, they're 6-17. There we go. Yeah, we won 3-4 game skid. We should not have lost against these peeps. But beat the Warriors, beat the Heat, beat the Raptors. Oh, look at this, Nolan. All this Charlotte stuff. We're definitely gonna play them. So we got Atlanta right now. Okay, I'm just making sure we better stay with the white jerseys because it'll end up. See, this is the thing about the Bulls. Like, their jerseys all look the same. Oh my gosh, so much different. TJ, Trae Young, dude, you guys got something with Trae Young, man. Trae Young is solid, man. I'm telling you, he's something to build around. He's gonna be a star, man. He's the closest thing we've seen to Steph, and he's like that new dude. I actually had him on my fantasy team as a rookie. I took a chance on him. I was looking at him, was like, dude, this dude can just. And I was one that kind of I was saying too at first. I was like, man, I don't know if his game will like go to the NBA. But then I watched like his first like preseason. I'm going Goga because he's on the Pacers. I would actually say Jackson Hayes, but Taco Fall is a big.
What part of your game do you
Bobo is dope though.
Into 2K20?
My shooting. I hope my 3-pointer is an A+ because in real life it is.
Because in real life.
Is there any
No, but Trae Young is good. Trying to think, y'all just got somebody.
They can't be too disappointed. Playing over 500 ball the last 10 games.
I'm forgetting on who the Hawks got, but they got better. They're about to get worked right here, though. I'm about to remember who it is because it's about to show me, though.
And a chance to take a look at some numbers for Young.
And right now, I was going to say, is it John or is it Josh? Was it the dude from the Blazers or the Blazers still have him?
Look a lot different than from the rest of the season, and by different. I mean better.
Looking at the starting five for the Atlanta Hawks. Young and Crabb are in the backcourt. Chandler Parsons out there with Hunter. And it's Len in at the five roaming the paint. And for the Bulls.
It's going to be a rough year for you.
Runs the point with Levine at the two. Porter and Markkanen.
The thing is Trae is that bright spot. And like, they'll be able to do stuff with Trae, man. I don't know, man. They might sneak into the playoffs because the East is not good. I mean, there's talent in the East, but it's not. It's just, it's always, it seems like it's always been the West has just got all, like, everybody. It's a foul, sir. Yes, sir. All right, DJ. Appreciate being here, man.
have the kind of unreal performances. The game's 68. You're just sitting there in amazement. You want to step up and say, you know what, I want to be there.
Come on, man. I do that drill all the time, and I miss my free throw. My fault for making you look bad, Girth.
They're excited for you to be playing, and they raise the level of your attentiveness to being competitive. On
I'm going to get skills all day on him if he tries that.
Inspirational to you.
And he lays that one in.
All day.
That's how you do it. Impressive play, explosive finish.
Yeah, sweet finishes like that. You see everybody get up. Look at the guys on the bench. They're fired up.
I remember who you're talking about, because I always get those two mixed up. What's his name on the Blazers? I think it's his name's Josh Collins. And dude, he was. Come on.
I think they prepared to face more defensive pressure, and that one didn't happen. And boy, they just rolled.
It took just a little bit of time, but once
Chandler Parsons, though, I don't really believe in him anymore.
Young with no one around.
He's probably better in real life than he is on 2K.
This is Trey Young's game right there. Rise and fire, and these shots are helping out the offense.
Brooks against Parsons. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. Nice shot by Brooks.
He's too good.
Nice move. He can do some damage in there if he's given the chance.
And about 2 minutes played here in the first quarter.
Give me the chance, coach.
Now here's Cram. He had 15 points last outing. Young for three. The shot misses. So the Bulls will take it the other way. They beat the Hawks during their last encounter.
Satoransky took off.
Not a close contest either. The last time they got together, everyone in the rotation played solid, and the bench was the difference.
Well, the second unit came in last game and just played
Trae Young, though,
basketball.
Dude, that dude.
I'm sure they'd like to do that.
And
again.
He looked like this offseason, I was watching stuff, like, dude.
Now here's Cram.
Look out. Like, I'm trying to take him again on my fantasy team this year.
Yeah, Len's not going to settle for anything
The freaking opening day is tomorrow, man. I need to text my buddy and see what he's doing with this league. Thought we'd have the draft by now.
Back to Satoransky. That drops and it comes off an assist from.
Oh my, that is dope. That is really cool. Look at this, guys. Amy just painted this. It like blends into the background because it's similar. I don't know if you can see the top, but there we go. That is cool, man. It's a plastic one, but she's got paint. It's like dark on the bottom, and that's really cool. Huh? Yeah, that's what I was going to say. It's the cup.
I want to make you guys a cup like this.
Mm.
But I wanted to practice.
That's dope. I like it. I love it. I want some more of it.
Christmas gifts. Well, recognizing the size mismatch and then turns it into an easy basket there.
I hope it's a bunch of socks. I love socks. I mean, if we're getting crazy looking socks, I at least want them to be like thicker. That's the thing with these crazy print socks. They're always so thin. You know? I don't know if you just heard that, but I wish you didn't hear that, because that was, Amy's breaking barriers in there.
But they just got down to business and never let up.
Impressive to see them on the road just step up.
I like socks. I never match them. I just love getting new socks. There's no better feeling than putting your feet into a new pair of socks. I have a sock fetish.
In the corner, it's Hunter. Len finds Young. And out of bounds as Chicago gains possession. And a look at the recent power rankings. Some interesting stories here in the early part of December. You take a look at the Celtics.
In the top 10.
They're gaining on some of the teams above them, trying hard to crack into that top five.
All right, TJ.
You know, right,
we'll see you in a little while.
The Bulls, they've been sinking on this list to start out the year. Not what they or really anyone else expected, but that's why you play the game.
On the court,
really?
For Atlanta.
Young and Girth surely gave it to him.
Chandler Parsons out there with Hunter, and it's Len in at the five down low.
And speeding up the
offense. All right.
Something the Hawks.
Here comes Atlanta.
Last season,
it was interesting for the Hawks, kind of zigging while everybody's zagging, as they made it a priority to get to the offensive glass, along with tons more field goal attempts in their offense, and that's been giving some defenses fits.
And we've got an update here.
Where's the
so let's
foul?
Check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Hi guys. Well, Big Daddy in the last game against
Big
the
Daddy. There it is.
He had 13 points, and along with what he did on offense, he had a big.
I hate not matching my socks, Dark. I really do.
What we've come to expect during this great run.
I agree there. I do agree.
Continue to stay high.
They just, yeah. You finally heard it there, though. They finally said it. Big Daddy here recently. Logan, what's up? Everything's A-okay. We got right back into things. We're good. We are gooched.
And I wouldn't be surprised if he tries to get it going early here tonight.
Every teammate in talking with them before the game says how much faith they have in him. They'll keep getting it to him.
Here's Young, and it's blocked. And it's going to be out of bounds.
Satoransky blocked it. Come on.
His shooting has been a little bit below par. You think about what this lead would look like if he was on.
Satoransky lays it up off the glass.
I mean, I'm happy you're scoring and doing stuff, Satoransky, but you just took my rebound. You just took my bucket.
That's going to be a wake-up call to the defense.
And Young kicks to Crab. Puts up a three. That one, no good.
Satoransky, get your ass away from me.
This one, they get to host the Hornets. And that's the third of four straight played at home. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Levine. Time now to look at
damn, Boz, 386.
And of course, it's still early. A little over a month gone in this new NBA season.
You kidding me?
Take a look at who's made it.
They got Ja up there.
Well, you look at Brooks. He's got no.
What? That's right. That's right. Did you tell him hot sauce?
Settled into that number two spot in the rankings.
They must not put him on the wings anymore. Well, I think, well, they did a couple times when the dude was up front, but I guess now maybe they're just like, you're using too much sauce. You're using too much sauce. We're going to put him in containers and sell him. Because you get lost in the sauce otherwise. You're none the wiser and you got sauce and you're lost. Don't smirk and jerk and then twerk your way on out.
I don't know how to twerk.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Oh, torn meniscus. At least they know.
The kind of talent he possesses to be ranked second already.
Not at all. I mean, we've
it might be a good thing. It might be a good thing, Logan. It really sucks for fans. Like, it really sucks because he was supposed to be, you know, it was going to be cool because the Pelicans are on opening night and all that stuff. It might be a good thing because now he maybe can get a little bit of that weight off. I'm not one that says he needs to lose all the weight. I think he should lose like 15, 20 pounds max. I think him being big like that is to his advantage, and he should try to keep that. But like, I don't know. Naturally playing in the NBA, and he's young. Like he'll thin out.
Markkanen's got himself on the board with three there. The Atlanta's gotten cold from deep in the second.
That's what's crazy, man. Greg Oden's from my state. I played against Greg Oden's high school in like a summer league. We had a summer league in high school.
Currently averaging almost 6 points a game.
It was cool because it was only like 30 minutes away from where we live. But I played against – he went to Lawrence North as the school. And I played against Lawrence North in that summer league. They were stupid big. Like everybody.
And he was 73% from the line a season ago, an average number.
Right, Dark? That's where all your hours are. If you want, man, if you want, I can switch it over. It makes more sense for you to be on the account that you stream from. So if you want me to, I'll just switch the currency you got and the hours or whatever. And then I'll give you mod on that account. And then take it off of this one or something like that. If you, I mean, you might not care, but I would. So if you want me to do it, I'll do it. Just let me know. Yeah. Okay. Cool. Yeah, I'll do it for you, man. I need to get back to writing stuff down. I'm gonna start writing stuff down again of like stuff I need to do for the stream. She's giving me double birds right now. She phone gave me double birds.
Hey, you guys are watching Bird Up, the worst show on television.
I just looked to my right because I saw her, and she's just double birding me, man.
This one could go down to the last possession.
You look getting beat by six. What is this?
He's really been playing well. Well, we'll find out if they were able to find an answer for him over the break. He was scoring with ease in that first half.
He stepped out to the 3-2. That was dope.
Out there, and I'm sure coach is going to make that a priority at halftime.
Porter and Markkanen, the duo went forward.
That was on me. That was on me.
The point with Levine at the two, and it's Brooks in at the five.
So Javi Baez going to be out of cover. Nice.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Baez was on.
The Hawks have been in rebuild mode for the last couple
was
of years.
Was he on the Reds for a little
bit? Season brings a lot of optimism. Passing to Luka Doncic.
I'm sucking.
Trae Young.
My Girth. Much double bird me again.
On down the stretch. His playmaking makes
she did back-to-back
better.
Double birds.
Also, they hope,
and Lowry took my rebound. Now the Hawks come on, Lowry. Come on.
The Andre Hunter. And they believe they're poised to make some noise in the East.
Girth gonna give it to you. Come on.
X gonna give it to you.
Look at them sneaks. Oh man, Girth is surely gonna give it to you. Girth is gonna give it to you.
They took that gamble with Don.
Girth's got that range, dude.
Thank you, DA. You know, Brent, there may be more of an emphasis on team defense than ever before. Who are some of the better help defenders that you've scouted in the NBA?
I put Rudy Gobert number one on this list because when you think about help defense, usually you're yelling it from the perimeter. And the reason that you're yelling at Kevin is that the player that you were trying to
Parsons for real move a certain kidding way like he. And the help he prevented me from bucketing that.
Rudy
you gotta be kidding me.
Better than anybody.
How are we
league?
Getting
That's
beat
why the
right
Utah
now,
Jazz
man?
Have a chance to
Girth is about to give it to
go
him.
Deeper into the playoffs, they got a back line of defense, and Gobert is pretty tremendous.
I love the guys, and Beverly might be in this
bah.
Category.
Again, look. Ooh, look what he did. Look what that man did. Oops. Oh my, oh my! We need a little bit of the yeah. That's what we need. Sorry. We just got to get a couple of shots here. It's too good. It's too good. That was a shot right there, though.
Yes. A little bit different in terms of help defense, on-ball defense, the way that Beverly and Marcus Smart and Paul George to that end are able to pester guys. That's one thing. But I'm yelling help because something's gone terribly wrong. Give me Gobert to fix that.
And yes, it's good. And now just a two-point Hawks lead.
And really just unselfish.
Girth's going now.
In the interior. That's the kind of pass a coach loves to see.
And Young kicks to Crab. A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. Down low. A fadeaway. Brooks grabs the board. Brooks has got his 7th rebound here tonight. Number 3, Levine, and it's good.
Baby. Brooks. There we go, Zach LaVine.
In the game.
Yeah, great outside shooting, really fueling this run.
Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over.
Yeah, talking about Joe Mama?
Tonight, guys, and instead of trying to shoot himself out,
talking about Joe Mama, Logan?
To start moving the ball.
Is that what you're talking about?
For his teammates.
So Chicago. On the wing, Brooks over Len. Brooks misses.
And that's just enough defensive pressure on him to throw off that shot. I bet he gets a good look at it next time and hits it.
All right, now a chance to set the floor courtesy of Gatorade. Fourth quarter action.
He goes Satoransky, dude. He's had a hell of a game.
We've got Reddish. Chandler Parsons out there with Len. And it's Young. And it's Hunter in at the three. And the call on the shot that sends.
Oh, I like Wendy's. Oh gosh, I think I'm gonna get something. Wendy's nuts. Yeah, I think that's what's gonna happen. Wendy's nuts. I think that's what's coming. I've never heard that one, but I feel like it just makes sense.
Come away with the lead, but I'm sure he's kicking himself over that last miss.
Young pass.
I knew it. I knew it, Logan.
Passes it to
Hunter. Trying to get me.
Young from outside. Brooks grabs the board.
Yeah, the three-pointer has not been his weapon in this one. He had one in the first quarter and still zero here in the second.
Tries yet again. Got a piece of it.
And putting that 7-2 wingspan to good use. Hunter can be an elite defender.
13-10, baby. Not a double-double.
The game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding has been the one differentiator thus far.
Shoots the three. Got that one. The Bulls lead Trey. Has been cut to just one.
He's got that thing
Young.
On him.
You hit a three on as Young, the kids you say. Can expect him to come right back at you.
Outside, Levine. Pass to Brooks. Releases. That's good. And it's Levine with the assist. Levine's got three assists in the game. The Hawks trail by three.
He just cashed that one.
Grab the pass to Parsons. He feeds it to Hunter. Good on the bucket. Hunter's got his first points of the night.
With a number of moves and shots to choose from, Hunter is scary. Nice bucket there.
Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. They get it back.
And a boy, Lowry. Let's go, dude. We got the starting lineup now. Keep me at center. I like it.
2 points there. That was an ideal scenario, really, for him.
Let's go.
And also a size advantage.
Bulls making a switch here.
Let's go.
Porter's checked in.
Hey, Marcus, Girth is certainly going to give it to
us. Don't give it to you.
Stretch four, outstanding at pulling the trigger from deep and not afraid to go inside and bang with the other bigs.
Porter with the steal. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break.
Move, Satoransky. My gosh, Satoransky.
Brooks lays it up and in off the pretty assist. Brooks has got 12 points here in the second half.
Yeah, nothing too fancy. Just getting the job done when they need to. Make every possession count.
2 minutes. Young against Porter. Now Crab. Here's Len.
Kidding me, Satoransky? I feel like I'm having to say your name a bunch.
Stepping up in a big moment there.
The Bulls leading by 4. And Zadaransky kicks to Porter. And there's the pass to Brooks.
Oh, Girth was about to give it to him. Oh, I just ripped my phones out.
Take it right at the D.
Girth was certainly about to give it to him. Girth is on the scene. Girth Brooks.
He hits the first one, and that puts them up by 5. So he gets them both, and it's a 6-point ball game.
I said I wanted to get 20 and 10 this game. Let's go, gamers!
Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the 44th.
Girth! With the rip! With the rip! Girth with the rip!
Oh! For Chicago.
And that just may put the finishing touch on this one. Not at all a time to get sloppy with the ball.
Young taking his time here.
That seals it. That's sealing it. That's sealing. Gosh dang it, Satoransky! Get out of here! Uh-oh. Uh-oh, Girth! Oh!
Rebounded by the Hawks. Satoransky will bring it up for the Chicago Bulls. Brooks, the pass to Levine. Back to Brooks. Shoots over Len, and the Bulls tack on 2 more.
Girth is silky smooth, baby. He is silky, silky smooth. He is slippier. He's as slippery as a baked potato in the middle of the ocean. That makes not a whole lot of sense.
Land against Brooks, fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points. So one free throw.
They can't handle it. They can't handle Girth. They can't handle Girth. MVP. Oh shit, gamers! They just started yelling MVP. That might be the first MVP chance Girth has ever gotten.
From deep, misses. And so Chicago takes this one. And by a big margin, some good competition with the home.
Get out of here. You just got smacked. I think made the difference. Woo! Heart piece, what's up?
In that opportunity and this
house.
Man. Girth came, and he conquered. Girth came and conquered. Oh, man. He came, he saw, he conquered. Let's go. Fellatio. Brooks Fellatio. Girth Fellatio.
Hey, Shaq here. You reminded me of me tonight on the boards, big fella. Talk about how much pride you take in that aspect of the game.
Big time pride, Shaq.
I want to make rebound sexy big again.
Fella, I'm looking to bring rebounding back to where it was. The days of you, Rodman, Malone, flexing with big numbers every night. That's my mission this year. Make rebounding sexy again. And tonight was just a taste.
Man, if I was with you, I'd start about to give you it all.
Damn, we're making rebound sexy again. You heard it here first, people.
What a great guy. I love having
having him on the show.
Strong agree. Yeah. We should have him on more often.
Yeah, I'm going to talk to James after the show. I'm sure he can make that happen.
Oh, yeah. Book it and cook it, Hank.
Dark, I'm talking about Girth. Girth Brooks, right here.
So, Jay, it seems like you're really in the
I'm going to tickle his chin.
What helped you get going?
These chin tickles. I'm going to grab his ear. Oh, can't get it.
Well, you know, we like to play a team game. So everything you get should come in the flow of the offense. I mean, if you're open, then the ball's supposed to find you. Tonight, I was a guy that was open and my teammates found me. So
Bop!
Shout out to them.
Shout out to them. Shout out to them. Shout out to the team. Another beer. Another piss. So much better today, and it's not boot. Talking about Michael Jordan, pick up Mike. It's getting kind of old, man. I don't know. Let's get another game in. We're going to get one more game in. I'm going to skip the practice. Are we at home again? Yep. We're going to go black jerseys. We're going to go one more game. And then we're going to end the stream. And then later on tonight, we're looking at probably...
Is there a player that you're looking forward to playing against in the NBA? Maybe someone you looked up to? Growing up.
We're looking at like 8:30, maybe.
All of them. I say this because I feel like if I can get the respect of all of them, then that means I held my own and I'm in a good spot of trying to be the best.
It's amazing. You're 7'7", and you played against an opponent in college that was 7'6". What was that like?
That was the weirdest game of my life. I never looked at somebody out of the eye, and that was my first college home game.
My clitoris? My clitoris? Who's my clitoris?
Well, you've been here at Summer League. What's your experience like?
It's being fun, you know. I'm still learning, like, you know.
Gosh dang it, Logan, you got me there.
It's different, you know, compared to college, so, you know, like a speed and wise and everything, but, you know, I've been having fun, yeah.
There's so many fans that look up to what you're going to be able to bring to the court. I know they're just eager to jump on the court with virtual Zion, so what would you tell the fans out there that are there to support you and your teammates?
Hey, man, I really appreciate the support. Hope you can keep bringing it. And just know that we're going to try to do something special this year.
It's the 2K MC, and here is what's going on in NBA 2K20. Right now, the Dirk Nowitzki spotlight has hit my team. Progress through the challenges based on Dirk's illustrious career and earn a pink diamond Sean Marion. The Matrix. And in the neighborhood...
Dang on,
Nance. This is Hank and the Hornet on 98.9 The Flex, the official home...
All right, let's get it. No. That one might be in the no-go zone. You should change it to dig or something. or pick, rider pick. I don't know.
Good Friday night to you, sports fans. You've come to the right place. Chance down.
That's a good one, Boston.
And I tell you, the excitement starting to ratchet up a little bit as the tallies start coming in.
You look at Levine. He's there in the top 10 in the Eastern Conference voting. The fans have really gotten behind him.
And that's the way it should be. I mean, you could make a case that he should be a starter, but there's just so many great players in the East. Just being in the top 10 shows how much respect the fans have for him.
And it's going to be an exciting showcase. We'll keep you updated with the results each day during the voting. Here's the starting group for the Charlotte Hornets. Williams and Zeller make up the front court. Rozier and Monk, they're the back court. And it's Batum in at the three spot. And for Chicago, Levine at the two with Porter at the three. Brooks is out there with Markkanen. And it's...
Wow! Damn.
An explosive high-level athlete. You see why Zach has won multiple dunk contests.
Knocks it loose.
Kidding.
Here's Rozier. Unable to get that one. Nice D from Brooks. And Sadoransky kicks to Brooks. And he banks in the layup.
And one of the things you love about this team, just seeing the bench go wild when Che makes an incredible play.
Hey, Che.
Quite common.
Hey, Che.
I think
to
see that Che is a beloved member of this team, and the way his teammates cheer for him, the reactions from the bench are priceless. Here's Zeller, and too long on the shot. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Alder.
Well, James Borrego had a few minutes to share with me.
That's who I was wanting to pass to, and it throws it to Markkanen.
Athletically than Zach LaVine. Coach made it clear their focus is trying to contain him offensively. Good luck with trying to keep him between the ball and the basket.
Thank you, David. Now, here's Monk. Sadoransky covering. Down to five on the shot clock. Three-pointer. Brooks grabs the board.
Oh, my God, they can't buy one. 0-for-4. Sometimes this happens.
Markkanen passes to Brooks. And no good that time. And Charlotte will come the other way.
He would have passed it to me the first damn time. I had an open layup.
It wasn't even close in their last matchup. And their offense just wasn't ready to...
See, I hate that call. They're calling a three-second call, and they've been across half court for all of 4 seconds. Like, that's stupid.
The Bulls have gone 3-of-4 from the field to start out the game. Well, Steve, we're just halfway through the season. What stands out to you so far in what you've seen?
Well, I think for me is those teams that are underdogs, they're overachieving. And some of those teams that we had out in front, we started to nitpick what's wrong with those guys. I think the halfway point is for teams both underachieving, overachieving, to start to really kick in. And some of those teams do and some don't.
Passes it to Monk. Just five to shoot. Batum with the three. They get it again. Zeller. Yep.
Damn it. I knew I shouldn't have faded out there.
Just like any
should have boxed him out.
That's a great play.
And the first time out of the game called.
Yeah. Yeah. I do remember that, Bossy. Was that all you? You're whipping out the master tank. I do remember that.
Here's Brooks. 26 points for him last game against Atlanta.
He was really aggressive on the glass, too. He really racked up on the boards out there.
Sadoransky, the pass to Hutchison. Now Brooks lets it go with a three. Nailed from 3-point
right
land.
In his eye.
Brooks has got the lead up to 6 now for Chicago. Last game for the Charlotte Hornets, it was a loss to the Nets in Brooklyn. Setting the 4 for the Hornets. Washington and Zeller are in the middle. Terry Rozier is out there with Batum, and it's Bridges in at the three.
Boom, baby.
And so Satoransky will bring it up for Chicago. They are coming off that win against Atlanta.
And the difference in that one, the efficiency from range. They really focused on getting good looks.
And if it wasn't there, each guy was willing to make the extra pass. Trust in his teammates.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
The Bulls shooting their first free throws of the game right now. Otto Porter Jr., he's checked in for the Bulls. Williams, he's checked in for the Hornets.
And last year, the Bulls having issues moving the ball was actually a strength for them in the seasons prior.
Totally agree. You look at all the relevant team assist stats. The Bulls were bottom five.
Like, why are we not dunking?
This team, they fall into too much isolation for stretches.
Hornets trail by eight. The pass to Zeller. Here's Rozier. Over to the wing. Bridges, no one around him. No good on the three.
With four spacing at a premium, they need him to hit these shots. Made just that one in the first.
Bulls shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
Yeah, looking over their percentage on the season, I think they will be thrilled with the number in terms of their free throw percentage, 79.
So for the Bulls, Markkanen comes in for Felicia, and Murray subbed in for Levine. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Hi, guys. Well, Big Daddy in the last game against
Big
the Hawks
Daddy.
Got the job done. He picked up 26 points and was his usual dominant self on the glass. He racked up big numbers in what was a really good performance. Can he carry it over tonight? We'll see, Kevin.
Excellent, David. Thank you. Greg, how impressive was it watching him completely take over?
Unstoppable. They won that game because of his effort and just his overall relentlessness.
And that's what every player has control of. His level of activity. It allows you to impact the game even if the shot isn't falling.
Batum scanning the floor. 3 minutes of action so far in the second quarter. For three, Bridges. Charlotte again missing.
He's doing what he can to help them cut into this lead. His shot just isn't quite there tonight.
There
you go. Playing with high energy, working the defense up the floor.
Having a hell of a game so far. Let's go.
Fast break results and a high percentage look. Not always the case these days.
Batum against Porter. Looking to end the run. And another shot.
Good foul.
And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Batum brings length and a versatile game to his spot on the wing. And his defense, always a big asset for this team. He's the kind of player that everybody needs to have out there.
Kind of a point right now. Guy.
Catching up on the changes for Charlotte.
Point Beyond center.
Checks in for Cody Zeller.
Coming at you.
Bacon subbed in for Bridges. And it's Murray with the jam.
I thought Markkanen was about to roll right there.
When he gets to the rim.
Hit it a little too early.
Get up a few notches higher. Pass to Bacon. Six to shoot. Back to Batum. The Hornets need to get a shot off here. Charlotte, no good that time either.
And I think that one could have easily have fallen for him.
Murray, the pass to Brooks. Drops in the layup for two.
Let's go.
Brooks has got 9 points.
And not hard to see why they are giving up points on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
Pass to Biombo. Now Rozier. Satoransky coming.
And that's his third.
Damn
foul.
It.
The chance you take leaving a man with two. Let's see if they'll sit him now until the half.
First. One second left. The shot will not fall. And so it's Chicago. Feeling good about their 17-point lead heading into the break. Their defense has been active and effective. Back to the action after this word.
That sound was freaking me out because it started as soon as I started hitting this.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. Look at Big Daddy, what a contribution.
In those first two quarters, he was pretty much an automatic bucket getter if he got it down low on the block.
I have to credit them for their patience offensively. They understood the matchup.
I'm surprised they still
took the necessary time to exploit it.
I was crowding them out being mad there.
And presented by Gatorade. Let's see who's all fueled up. Four to start the third. Taking a look at the Bulls. Porter and Markkanen, the duo, went forward. Sadaransky runs the point with Levine at the two. And it's Brooks in at the five spot. Now let's go to the sideline and catch
Why are we not dunking?
David Alder.
Charlotte's had to wait a bit the last few years. Now, the city hosted the All-Star game last season. But for the Hornets, they've gone three seasons without a playoff appearance and 15 seasons without winning a playoff series. In that time, the franchise has had seven head coaches and a shifting front office. But Buzz City is hoping that its wait for playoff relevance will end soon. Kevin?
We all are. David, thank you. Steve, we're seeing teams around the league putting up a lot of three-point shots. I'm sure you would have enjoyed playing in this era so much with that green light shooting three.
I would, Kevin. Getting a chance to shoot maybe five or six more three-point field goal attempts takes your numbers up. But I also think a lot of these teams are copycats. Everybody can't shoot the three. Work on your game and what's better. Empty possession. You don't want to miss these easy looks.
Passes it to Markkanen. Over Williams. And the Bulls tack on two more.
Three out of four coming out of the half. Showing good execution on the offensive end.
And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. Monk for three. Gets it to go from beyond the arc.
And Monk has proven that he is a terrific scorer from the perimeter. When he's in rhythm, he has no problem letting it fly.
Brooks misses. Hornets trail by 18. There's the pass to Rozier. Teardrop shot. Markkanen pulls it in. The Bulls have gone 3-5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there. Porter dishes to Brooks.
Kidding?
Zeller grabs the board. Zeller's got four rebounds in this game. Monk, the pass to Rozier. Charlotte moving it around. Sadaransky against Batum. Five on the clock. Back to Zeller. Shoots over Sadaransky. Shot by Zeller, no good. The Bulls leading by 18. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Yeah, easy call.
And the Charlotte franchise has been stuck for so long with Kemba Walker.
That's right, Heartbeast. He's back.
Greg, is it time for them to hit the reset button?
A rebuild does seem in order. I'm not sure they have the stomach for it, but they need to tear it down to the studs and start over.
Here's what Chicago's going with right now. Young's checked in for Markkanen. Valentine comes in for Otto Porter Jr. And it's Ryan Arcidiacono in for Sadaransky. So an almost entirely new group in now for Charlotte. Yambo, he's checked in for Zeller. Hernan Gomez comes in for Williams. Bridges, he's checked in for Nicholas Batum. And Dwayne Bacon subbed in for Terry Rozier. Here's Levine. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle. And now a three-point
Zach Levine, baby. Dude's dope. He gave me a minute.
Stolen.
Huh?
And so it's
what?
Three.
Tell him you wanted more. Why didn't you tell him?
They keep charging me for everything that they don't normally charge me for.
I'm about to start saying
going
something.
To end up in the record books as a blowout.
Was he the one in front?
Performance for Chicago.
This was a team performing to its fullest capability.
A hugely satisfying win. A game that not many will soon forget. And on the other side, one that...
Give me a second and I'll pour it all on.
I think most will try to forget.
And for the year now, they'll be tallying their 16th win.
And once they polish off this win, they'll be one more victory away from sweeping the season series.
And what a tremendous standout performance it was for Brooks.
I thought he did a good job of filling out the defense early on. Then once he found his groove, he stayed aggressive throughout.
On the floor for Charlotte, Rozier and Monk, they're the backcourt. Bismack Biyombo is out there with Cody Zeller. And it's Hernan Gomez in at the small forward. Brooks kicks to Murray. Back to Brooks for three. Good, and the assist goes to Murray.
Taking no chances, they go on one last run to seal the deal.
Not messing around at all. They were focused, relentless, and they got the job done.
And that one's good, Archie Diacono.
Impressive job by the players, coaches, and don't discount the impact of these fans.
They gave the team tremendous energy tonight. The fans were fantastic. It was a true home court advantage. Well, what did Coach tell us? He wanted each guy to contest shots and rebound tonight. That's exactly what we just saw.
Brooks with the bucket.
Boy, you have to be impressed with the offensive production. Nice. They have got it firing on all cylinders.
It's been a tremendous job of play calling and execution. They just continue to increase this lead.
I thought he just banged that thing too.
And by a big margin. It was a tale of two teams tonight. One that goes into
smacked him.
It's time now to go courtside as he sends you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Kevin, thank you. Congrats on the win tonight, Che. You guys have come out of the gate very strong this year. What has been the key to the hot start?
Hey, DA, man, we know what's at stake, man. We're on a mission this season. You know, we won't be taking any prisoners. It's get up our way or get run over, man.
We're gonna live
that's
by
how
that.
We see it. So let's get it.
That is a team that's going to be tough to move around and beat down the stretch. Congratulations, guys.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much.
Oh,
ready to do this?
We got 2000 BC.
What's up, bro? You wanna
look at them shorts?
We can get you on tomorrow.
And welcome back to the show. We're joined now by Che, one of the top young players in the league. Che, thanks for joining us, man.
Hey, thanks for having me, guys.
Yeah, I'm wondering, what are your thoughts on some of the chatter around the league that you could be looking at an all-star selection this year?
I don't shy away from pressure or big expectations. So it feels good that people, you know, think me that way. I think of myself that way, too. If you're not trying to be one of the best players in this league, then I don't know what you're doing out there.
That's what I'm talking about, baby. My man Che is a worry.
Yeah. Do you?
Dude, exactly, Dark. That was that was the goal. That was the goal. We wanted that pop out effect, like coming at you.
So who knows what's gonna happen? But I do consider myself part of that upper tier, you know.
Hell yeah, Che.
Well, great stuff as always, Che. Thanks so much for joining us.
No problemo.
All right, I think it's time to play.
Thanks.
That's cool, like, as he took it off, you could, like, the sound kind of went away.
Yes?
Look at that shirt.
First one?
Yeah.
All right, I'll see you now.
Okay.
All right. But that's the best.
You guys are on fire. What's been the key to your success these past few games?
Ted, you know, I think it's just everyone being in sync, I guess. You know, coaches pushing all the right buttons. We're executing on both sides of the ball. Treating every possession like it matters. When you're at this level of competition, there's very little that separates the best teams from the worst. So attention to detail is very, you know, it's major.
Yeah, I got a lot of star power. Yeah. Yeah, I got a lot of star power.
That's so perfect. Oh gosh. Oh my girth, rather. Alright, so let's see here, ladies and gentlemen. back up to 6,000. I kind of, my ball handle's all the way up. How many is it going to take to get, there we go, to 84, that's what I was going to say. Might as well get our free throw all the way. Oh. I want to go rebound. Let's go all rebound. Hell yeah. Brings us to 84 too. I want to see what it has me as like ranked against other people. Well, we'll look at our stats here. Yeah, let's look at the, we'll look at the rookie report. We'll look at the season awards here. I haven't got any player of the weeks. Definitely got rookie of the month. There you go. I can't believe that, man. We're in the All-Star vote. Look at that. Okay, look. Already passed DeMar. Why is DeMar DeRozan in the small forward again? Vucevic is averaging 21 and 11, though. Hey, we're gonna have a hard time making the. I used to be the rookie reporter. Oops. I want this. Yeah, there we go. The position. So close shot, way under, mid, way over, three, way over. Okay. It's that high on centers? Like, I don't. This seems crazy. Okay, cool. Our rebound. That's why I was wanting to see where our rebound rating was compared to like our position. So we're above average and right at, we'll end up being above average, it looks like, on both. All right, cool. Blocks right there. Cool. That stuff's got to raise up after a while. All right, last game, and then we'll call it a stream. Girth being humble and she.
NBA season tips off on Tuesday the
26th. How many likes we got?
Which means my team will be heating up as NBA games are played.
20 likes even. I like it. I like it.
If that player does well in the NBA. And moment cards will hit the mode, immortalizing amazing performances. And come back to the neighborhood at 9 p.m. for
Here we go. Going against the Clippers, dude. One of the best teams in the league. Easily. This is a huge, this is going to be a tough game. Oh, they put Satoransky now at point guard. I kind of like it. He's big. 19-8. We're 16-11. Ooh, the jerseys they got.
Looking at some stats for George, and something has really.
Are they the old school? Yeah, they're like the old.
Wow, this is the line is much better than it had been prior. Sometimes that's how it works. A switch flips, and all of a sudden, you're locked in.
Here are the starters for Los Angeles. The two stars, George and Leonard, fill up the forward slots. Beverly and Williams, the guard tandem. And Harrell's in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And for Chicago, Levine at the two with Porter at the three. Brooks is out there with Markkanen. And it's Satoransky in at the one.
Get it out.
A hand on it, and he's able to get it back.
Get it out.
But they're recovered. Markkanen finds Satoransky.
some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Hey, Chris, what do you think is the best way for a coach who has lost a locker room to get it back?
You just got to be honest and open. I mean, you know, everyone's adults, and if you can't handle the information, then the onus is on that player. But just look at what happened in Minnesota last year.
Let's go.
It's just terrible in the locker room. It's not good for the fans, especially the hometown fans that believe in this young team. And so a lot of times it just comes down to clear, open communication.
Blue Will's probably not going to start. He never starts. He's like the best sixth man ever. It's like his thing. He comes off the bench and kills him.
Inside the three-point line.
Bob.
That drops and it comes off an assist from Brooks.
And that'll start us off already. You can feel the tension in this arena.
Oh, man, these fans are pumped. I expect them to be loud tonight. Should be a great game.
Leonard doesn't go for him. Excellent D there from Markkanen. He has a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin, I was able to talk with Doc Rivers a few minutes ago. He understands they're facing a team that can put up points in a hurry. He said they need to put forth a great effort defensively to prevent scoring.
Let's go, y'all.
They can't afford to let those guys get hot and stay hot. We'll see who wins the battle of wills here tonight.
All right, David, sounds like they're very concerned about preventing an early run by their opponent.
No doubt. You don't want to play catch-up if you can avoid it. They're going to lean on their defense to try to keep this game in check.
It'll take tremendous energy and focus.
Let Girth lead the way.
They give themselves a good chance to get the win.
Leonard against Markkanen. And it's
deep.
It's not easy to keep him from converting those. I mean, the D has to be airtight.
Here's Brooks. Markkanen trying to break loose. And again,
he's too good.
Another make there from Brooks.
They've come out with guns blazing. 4 for 5 from the field.
He started off perfect. 6 points, 3 rebounds, an assist, 2 blocks. A steal.
Stolen by Brooks. And Porter, here we go.
Girth having the game of his life so far.
The mindset of Porter. When he's driving inside, he wants to dunk it hard every time.
Beverly against Satoransky. 1:53 left to play in the first quarter. Outside Williams. Shot clock at 5. Over Levine. And again, it's the Clippers missing.
Oh, their movement is good, and they get the ball into the right hand. Now, usually, he drops those in between.
Look at the team. And now you see. Look at the team. Oh, they took me out. I was on a super hot streak. All right. Still got me in takeover mode, type. Toy.
The pass to Brooks. Inside. Hutchison passes to Felicio. Here's Archie Diacono. He's guarded by Williams. And that one's good. Brooks. Brooks has got 8 points.
And we're seeing some great ball movement.
I got to guard Kawhi now.
Oh yeah, Kevin, last season was not a successful one for the Bulls. They had the 5th worst record in the NBA. Although it got him a nice draft pick, it was another step in a long
beat. That was on you, Archie, not me.
So for the Clippers right now, Shamet and George at the 2 Shamet. And the 3.
Shamet and George
in the middle, and it's Williams at the point guard.
When he was in high school in California, Kawhi won the state's Mr. Basketball Award. And you look at the list of guys who've won that award over the years, it has a lot of the
on fire. You gotta give me that
on it.
And for the Bulls, Chris, they had a young team and they knew it wasn't their time.
Yeah, the team decided to move on from the Hoiberg era as well, Kevin. I mean, they dealt with a lot of injuries during last season, and the team is still searching for an identity.
From 8. Up again. Controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
I swear it's like every time I turn on the...
Oh, what terrific hustle.
The he's takeover mode, I do worse.
For the rebound.
Greg, he's ferocious.
I think it's
because
I take bad shots maybe
up
with it on.
George dishes to Harrell.
Who knows?
Passes to Shamet.
Or worse shots, rather.
Kicks it out to Leonard. But 3.
I can't believe he missed that.
Brooks has got 5 rebounds tonight. Shoots over Shamet.
kidding?
Rebound, Felicio, and he uses the glass on the lane.
He's going against Shamit right there, but he's got to finish it. A lot of effort and focus
on the backboard. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Hi guys, well, Big Daddy in the last game against
Big
the
Daddy.
Tremendous. He ended up with 21 points, and he was in a groove all game long, both the free throw line and behind the arc.
Stupid chat. Really Felicio is killing, though.
To be in rhythm and always in the right place at the right time. Kevin?
Yeah, David, in stretches, he was absolutely dominant. Greg, he'd love to match that performance tonight.
This team needs his contributions. When he's right, he makes winning plays time and time again.
Yeah, Greg, it's all about getting into a comfort zone early. When he does that, he can be very difficult to contain the rest of the way.
Well, for so much of what...
Let's see the face on this. Oops. That's so good.
With his defensive impact, he is one of the top defenders in the league at his position, if not the best.
So for the Bulls,
so good.
Markkanen comes in for Felicio, and Zach LaVine subbed in for Ryan Arcidiacono. Green, he's checked in for the Clippers. Patrick Beverly comes
We've
in.
Got
for
some
Williams.
Beauties on screenshots on this stream. It's been a lot of good things.
Outside
things.
Leonard. Just five on the clock. And he gets it back. There's Harold.
Well, step in the right direction. Markkanen must continue to make these kinds of efforts on defense.
To the inside.
Oh, you gotta finish that, Girth. You gotta finish it, Girth.
It's just a fluke miss.
Leonard finds Harold.
That was a fluke miss. Gosh dang it.
And in terms of size,
you gotta finish that, Girth. That was, what? Why are you throwing it to me?
As big as any of them. Thanks to that terrific leaping ability.
With one on the clock, no good on the shot. And so it's the Chicago.
All right, two quarters to play, guys. Girth has had an incredible game against easily. I mean, this team that we're playing against, they're projected to win the championship. Lakers or Clippers, they're the top two teams.
And for those of you just
in Vegas,
in, thanks for being with us.
As they
the
say,
the second half of this game still to play. It's been a clinic out there by Big Daddy.
Big Daddy, is that a clinic?
On the block was incredible there in that first half.
Bringing the physicality. I mean, they kept working it to him, and he kept delivering.
Third quarter action. Brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. Taking a look at the Bulls. Porter and Markkanen, the duo at forward. Valentine out there with Satoransky. And it's Brooks in at the five, roaming the paint. Satoransky, the pass to Porter. Back to Satoransky. Good ball movement here by the Bulls. Markkanen dishes to Brooks. The league has cracked down. C-Webb on flagrants.
You kidding?
Leaving the bench. You think
thank you, Markkanen. I just can't finish, apparently. I'm making all the right moves, I feel like.
The league has given on flagrants. Don't want the flagrants of the pass. My friend Kevin McHale, he says Rambis just ran into his elbow. That wasn't even a flagrant foul on that play, if anybody remembers that old play that I'm talking about back in the Celtics-Laker days. But how about today? My thing, Kevin, is just don't...
Oh, come on, Valentine.
I think we all know what a flagrant is. Let's keep the new flagrants as flagrants and no flopping. If you flop, no flagrants. Games are too important. You don't want that flagrant one, flagrant two, a shot and the ball. It can change.
change the momentum of the game. I think the league and the refs are doing a great job.
I just can't finish, man. I've had my shots.
And Chris, what about players leaving the bench when there's something going on?
I'll tell you what, the league has always been great about that. What's funny is if you watch the games, there's an assistant coach that is designated.
Here's Porter. Kick out to Levine. Zadaransky looking around for the lead. Nice shot by Brooks. She's
got 13 points. Good anticipation. Look at him hopping away.
He knows exactly where to go with that ball.
On the wing, George. Defended by Young. And the wide open shot from Green. And that won't go, missing the go-ahead bucket.
More good work on the glass there. When it's all said and done,
no
rebounding might tell the story in this game.
Brooks with no one around. That's good, and it's Levine with the assist.
Let's go.
Their effort today, terrific.
Let's go.
Williams with the ball from deep three-point range, and no good in the last second attempt this time. And as
Girth.
The third quarter, a great
game. Girth. Just gonna give it to you.
Hit Chicago, finishing the quarter on a tremendous. Here now a chance to show you our assist of the game, and it's presented as always by State Farm.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feat.
I mean, well, if you're the coaching staff, I mean, you're pumped up. This highlight will not only make it on the TV, it'll make it into the film session.
3/10 quarters behind us. One more to go. Thanks for being with us as we begin the fourth. And on the floor for the Clippers here in the fourth, we've got
Paul
Williams.
Just abused him.
Green is out there with Kawhi Leonard. Then it's Ivica Zubac, and it's George in at the two. Dean passes to Brooks. Rebound by the Clippers.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender.
Yeah, you can see why he's established that reputation. Strong understanding of how to defend at the rim.
Here's Williams. And the bucket is good.
Damn.
3-point point right. Chance here for him.
All right, Luke.
Taking it up strong.
Lewis Williams.
Size, he does not lack for confidence.
No, absolutely not. And in his mind, no one can stop him on that, no matter the size.
And Williams is sort of the classic instant offense guy. Whether he's coming off the bench or starting, he can provide a spark whenever they need one.
Brooks kicks to Levine. Down to 5 on the shot clock. No good from outside.
Oh, how did I get?
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean,
damn, that's 3 points.
On those nearly every time.
Ooh.
And so Levine will bring it up now for the Bulls. They've led by as much as 10. It's off to Oklahoma City for him after
this game. I just can't hit anything now.
To look forward to. Sets in motion a 4-game road trip for him. It's blocked. And they're moving it up.
Marketing.
Marketing. Zadaransky's got his first.
Zadaransky finishing. Oh, my gosh.
Transition, the most consistent way.
Oh my God.
Awesome. 3 minutes, 25 seconds, swept by two guys. Kids dancing. Gosh dang it. Why'd you do this, dude? What the heck is
how easy it is?
What the heck is here?
To put up points. Attacks from all spots on the floor and has a great touch on that shot, especially for a man his size.
Catching up on the changes for the Clippers. Andres Harrell, he's checked in for Zubac, and it's Patrick Beverly in for Jermichael Green.
Missed, hell yeah.
Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sideline.
Well, during the break, I listened in on Doc Rivers talking to the team. He said, we're too concerned with their shooters right now. We've got to close off the inside. They are gutting us. He pleaded with his guys. Come on, let's take a stand.
That's good.
Kevin?
And really, Greg, the only knock on Markin is that he can be too passive at times.
And I suspect that will fade as he grows more comfortable in the league. You have to remember how young he is and missed a good amount of time with injury during that second year.
George looking around. Brooks grabs the board. Brooks has got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one. Levine with it. Leonard picks him up.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
Levine on the assist by
there we go.
And that set them apart today, guys. Their success with the mid-range.
Web, web.
Pass to Harrell.
Web, web.
No good there. Nice D from Levine. The Bulls leading by five. Inside, Brooks. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
All right, we'll take the rebound in the bucket. Points in the quarter. I'll take that all day. I'll take getting blocked, get that extra rebound, get that bucket. What else?
From the field in the fourth quarter so far. They are 2 of 6. Leonard inside, guarded by Porter.
Hell of a shot. Good.
Yeah, and from mid-range, Leonard's jump shot is money. It doesn't matter if it's off the dribble or catch and shoot. He never loses his touch. And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that, that's your only option.
Gets the first, and that increases their lead to 6. Second one is good. Getting both at the line, and it's a 7-point game.
Yeah, those free throws helping him to make the lead even safer.
Brooks against Beverly. Outside for George. Over Markkanen. Misses off the left iron.
It's really a tale of two quarters. Shot it so well in the last, but this one can't get anything to fall.
And there's the whistle.
I got stuck on the dude. Come on, man. Really?
Clippers trail by 7. We played just over 3.5 minutes now in the fourth quarter. Williams against Levine. Pass to Beverly. From deep.
Rebound. God, that was my double-double.
On the wing, Levine. Back to Brooks. Shoots over Leonard. Brooks with the bucket. And the Bulls
Brooks.
By 9. Saw the opportunity.
I hope they don't take me out.
Did not.
I just want
that
one more rebound. The dude took my rebound.
You could tell they wanted that one. I know that's it.
And the Clippers call time here. They're down by Girth. 9.
Girth again.
53 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And now we've got a moment for our Jordan player of the game, Big Daddy. And
Big Daddy.
It really has been his night. He's done a lot of things well, but his scoring really put him over the top. You can see how determined he's been every time he's gotten his hands on the ball. Great drive and also great focus offensively.
The lift he got from this home crowd has been obvious. There's nothing fans love more than getting a big game out of someone other than one of their stars. Back to Porter. It's Brooks on the wing for the 3. Drills it from outside. Brooks has got the lead up to 10 now for the Bulls.
And you can sense that these fans, these players, they are ready to celebrate.
You know they are sure.
Yes!
Come on, the finish line is in sight. All they have to do is play.
Yes, there's the double-double.
Dishes to Levine. And there's the pass to Brooks. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. And he makes the first.
What a way to end the stream. Listen to that. MV Girth, MVP.
And both free throws good for Brooks.
Girth is gonna get
called. Give it to you.
For a comeback, just went out the window with those.
And so Chicago takes this one.
Hell of a game. Hell of a way to end the stream. We got all W's, no losses. We started off the stream. It's a lot of controversy and crazy stuff happening. Everything worked out. We didn't lose our saves. All is well. The best game we had the entire stream was the last game. Boom, got a badge. I said we were going to get a badge by the end of the stream. Ooh. Heck of a time. Heck of a time. Thank you for stopping by. This has been Ambiguous Gaming, where we have the pleasure in the most non-sexual manner possible. Hit the like. Hit the subscribe button if you're new.
For your health.
For your health. Appreciate everybody. I'm going to be playing Remothered Tormented Fathers later tonight, continuing Ambiguous Scaretober. It'll probably be about 3 hours from now. Get ready to check it out. We'll see you guys later. Appreciate it. Peace. Thank you.